This man is delivering the goods. Over the next few days and nights, we'll see if our contestants can do the same. It's the greatest endurance test ever seen on British television. They're in it for the long haul. It's Touch the Truck. Here at Lakeside Thurrock is the host who's going to take them by the hand. It's Dale Winton.
Hi, and welcome to Touch the Truck. An endurance test second to none, where over the next long days and even longer nights, 20 determined competitors will be pushing themselves to the limit to win this amazing 4x4 off-road sports utility vehicle, or truck as I like to call it. And let's be honest, nothing I like more than a good truck. So, what do our contestants have to do to win it? Well, let me tell you, this Toyota will literally be in our contestants' hands. The last one to let go of it wins it. It's that simple. The one who survives drives. And in a matter of minutes, our 20 plucky truckers will take their places on the touchline and put one hand on the truck. Then all they have to do is keep it there until they're the last one standing. Sounds simple, doesn't it? Here's the deal. They're not allowed to sleep, sit, or slump, because if they do, our team of referees will disqualify them. That's right, our truck touchers have to stay awake and upright for anything of up to 5 days. Believe me, this is an incredible test of endurance and stamina. Just think, they'll be fighting sleep deprivation, physical pain, and mental exhaustion. And on top of which, they've got cameras following their every move, 24 hours a day. But you know, despite that, every single one of our truck touchers is totally and utterly convinced that they're gonna win. Don't believe me? Have a look at this.
I once stayed away for 4 days playing darts in Hull.
I really want to win Touching the Truck because I'm a greedy girl.
I do realise that physically, mentally, this is going to be the hardest thing I've ever done.
I have a baby 4x4 and I'd love to have a beast of a 4x4.
I want this truck more than anything. It's my dream car and the only one I can fit in.
My husband would never forgive me if I didn't win.
How I intend to win this is by using meditation and out-of-body experience.
And I'm here to win the car for to transport my baby safely.
I want to win the truck so I can convert it into money so that I can publish a book of poems that I've been writing.
Longest time I've stayed awake is 4 days up a tree, standing around this truck being no problem.
I want to win because that car is mine.
Wonderful, wonderful. Well, no sign of nerves there, but only one of those confident contestants is going to drive away this truck, and that will be one lucky trucker. The rest of them will fall by the wayside here at Lakeside. Well, our squad of referees and touch judges are here to make sure that everyone is playing by the book, and their job is to terminate any toucher who breaks the rules. That means falling asleep, just leaning against the vehicle, or merely lifting their hand off the truck. Now, obviously, there are medical risks with an endurance challenge like this, and we will have a team of medical experts on hand 24 hours a day to keep a close eye on how our challengers are doing. But all of our contestants are ready, willing, and hopefully able to face up to the challenge ahead. You will be getting to know those 20 people very well over the coming days and nights. You can even keep an eye on them live on the Channel 5 website. But now, let's meet them for the first time, the guys with their eyes and their hands on the prize. Here they are. Please welcome Paul Sinclair, 35, our motorbiking evangelical minister from London. Colin Caffrey, 27, from Kent, a Millwall supporting pest exterminator. He's got the killer instinct. Pam Hardy, 44, a divorce secretary from Essex. Now, the new love of her life is a 4x4, and she would love to get her hands on this one. Adam Giorgio, a 31-year-old cabbie from Essex who uses his taxi as a mobile passion wagon. So he's used to having his hands on a body. Sylvester John, 43, from London, works for a supermarket chain and needs the car to pay his two mortgages. You know, he's never had a day off, and from now on, he's on nights too. Kay Rigby, 22, a bright and bubbly Bradford girl who plans to write a book while she's here, but has still yet to pass her driving test. Jason Crump, 30, ex-professional basketball player from Cheshire. He'll go through all the hoops to win this car, and it's the only sort he can actually fit into. David Guest, 50, from Somerset. David's a roofer who's into meditation, astral projection and fishing. Mary Moore, 41, from Bristol. This one's a hopeless romantic and a hopeless insomniac who loves travelling. Her favourite film is Sleepless in Seattle. Bill Kerr, 27, from Kent. He's a heavy metal member of a medieval war reenactment society, so he's trained in siege mentality. Debbie Stinchcombe, 39. She's from Wiltshire, runs an animal sanctuary, but hates swearing. Jerry Middleton, 40, from Surrey. He's a vegetarian environmental activist and meditating road protester who lives on a bus, fancy. Christopher Robinson, 38, from Buckinghamshire. He went from the Marines to the Foreign Legion, so he's sure the force is with him. Wendy Hesketh, 27. Wendy's a dancer from London. She's also part-time maths and PE teacher and hates olives, but she enjoys trampolining and candle making. Bobby Shah, 27, a London city slicker. He loves his work and making money. And when he's not being popular at work, he's the life and soul of the party. Uma Abdullahu, 20, a bodyguard from London. For the next few days, he'll be putting his own welfare first. Sophie Bracker, 30, a salsa dancer from London. She's been an actress, but the last thing she'll find here is a casting couch. Jimmy Trott, 42, currently homeless in London. He loves Elvis, writes the big issue, and for him now, to win Touch the Truck is everything. Davinia McFarlane, 22, a power napping fitness instructor and psychology student from London. And finally, Tim Ashby, 57, from Oxfordshire. He's got a stiff upper lip and wants to take the truck home and a new world record. Good luck. Oh, I wish you luck. So there you see them, 20 truck touchers. Each of them is convinced that they alone have the willpower and stamina to stay awake for as long as it takes to be the last one standing. But which one of them will be able to go without sleep the longest and will claim this classy chassis as their prize? Well, it's time to find out. We have the touchers. We've got the truck, so let's touch the truck. You're all in position. Yeah. Gloves are on. Yeah. You each know the rules. You have to stand unsupported and unsleeping with one hand on the truck. One question. Are you ready to feel the steel?
Yeah!
Who's going to win?
Me!
Okay. It's time to touch the truck. I wish you lots of luck. I really do. Here we go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Touch the truck. Well, this is just the beginning, and you may think it looks easy now, but as the hours and days pass, this won't be a walk in the park. How long they'll be here is anybody's guess, but I can tell you that the world record for this event is held by American Warren Hearn and stands at 125 hours, which adds up to more than 5 days. Could you stand it? After the break, we'll be finding out more about our contestants and be on the lookout live for any early casualties, but if they want the prize, they'll have to keep their hands on it. They're not going anywhere. Make sure you don't. Welcome back to Lakeside Thurrock, where we've got 20 touchy truckers with their palms pressed against the paintwork of this top-of-the-range truck. Now, only one of them can win it, and over the next hours, days and nights, they have to stand unsupported, unsleeping and under stress with one hand on the metalwork. You could say it's the ultimate panel game. Let's go and have a chat to some of them. So, Jason.
Hi, Dale.
How tall are you?
6'10".
My goodness, well, welcome to Touch the Truck.
Thank you.
It's the early days yet. So, do you think that your height might be an advantage or a disadvantage?
Oh, definitely an advantage. I mean, day three is going to be some smelly armpits around here, so I'm going to be up here, you know, in the nice fresh air.
Do you have any special techniques you're going to be using for this?
One is just to take whatever pain comes to me and just deal with it. And another one is just mental focus. Yeah. Mental is to physical as four is to one.
How long before you start to ache a bit, do you think? How long do you think?
I don't think the competition's actually going to get started for a couple of days, so I'm hoping I can go a day or two without, you know, too much pain.
Will you be here at the end to drive this away?
I'll be here.
Will you?
I'll be here.
Along with 19 others who also...
If that's the case, then we're going to be here 2 weeks.
Okay, well, I wish you luck. Don't shake my hand. Don't take your hand off the track. Hi, Kay.
Hello.
Lovely to see you. What is a nice girl like you doing standing with all these fellas around a truck? What on earth made you do this?
You got to be in it to win it.
So you want to win it?
I'd love to.
Yeah, I mean, obviously you want to. Are you going to win it?
I don't know, but I'll try my best.
Actually, this is the first time I've spoken to anybody that said no, I might not win it, because everybody else.
You said no.
You said I'm hoping to win it. But what are you going to do with the truck? Because I'm told you haven't got a driving license.
No, I'll try pass my driving license, and then I'd like to sell it and hopefully write a book.
Someone told me you're going to write a book while you're here.
No, I'll try it with my head, maybe, but not.
How are you going to pass the time?
Just think a lot and talk.
Yeah?
I'll probably really annoy these people by the end of 2 days.
I was going to say, because you've got him, he's so tall next to you.
I know.
It's really weird because you're looking, well, you look like really different. You've been staring at his chest all the time, haven't you?
I know, it's quite nice. <That's> it.
Well, I wish you luck, Kay. Welcome.
You.
David.
Hello, Dale.
Now, you've chosen the window.
Yes, my friend, yeah.
Yeah, don't, whatever you do, don't take your hand off that. I'm told that you're into meditation.
I am, yes.
And someone said that you were going to put yourself into a trance to keep yourself going.
Later on, as it progresses, Dale, that's what I intend to do.
Yeah, and you're a roofer, right?
I'm a roofer.
Not for the moment, you're not.
No.
What techniques are you going to use to put the others off? Because let's be honest about it. There are 19 others around the truck at the moment. You want to be the last man standing.
Obviously.
So you're going to get to know these guys and girls pretty well. What do you think you're going to do? Have you got anything special you're going to do?
to put... Really, it's a case of mind over matter. I intend to use that.
Right.
I don't mind, and the rest don't matter, Dale. If I can.
Well, that is great. Don't take your hand off the truck.
No.
I wish you luck. We'll get to the others a bit later on. Well, who's a hot favourite and who's a rank outsider? You can log on to the website at www.channel5.co.uk/touchthetruck and check out the odds for yourself. In the meantime, here are the top truck touchers that I think might just go all the way.
Christopher Robinson is a 38-year-old ex-Royal Marine and ex-French Foreign Legionnaire from Aylesbury. With this CV, Chris is no stranger to a tough challenge.
My military background, the French Foreign Legion, has helped an awful lot. I've had to work very long hours and maintain very high standards, and I feel with that training and the pride of being a Legionnaire, it will see me through to the end. I do wish all the other contestants a lot of luck in the show. I give them a lot of respect. It isn't going to be easy for any of us, and I do apologise to them for winning.
Contestant number 12, Jerry Middleton, is a 40-year-old eco-warrior from Kingston. Jerry once infamously appeared on Twyford Down with his young son Benjamin and psyched out a digger driver during a road protest. Shortly after this definitive moment, Jerry ditched the suit and big sunglasses and became a full-time eco-warrior.
I'm really positive about winning, and I've got something really that I want to do when I win, which is start a political party.
Jerry's long career of staying awake underground and up trees may well have been good training for a long stint on the truck. Or could it be contestant number 7, Davinia McFarlane from East London? 22-year-old Davinia is a psychology student who works in a gym, so she's one of the most physically fit contestants at Truckside. A kickboxing fanatic, she has modified her daily gym routine to strengthen up for the tough competition ahead.
I've got the edge because I'm fit, I'm strong, I've got a lot of good supporters behind me who are going to keep me going. I'm going to win.
Contestant number 1, Emer Abdullahu, is a 20-year-old bodyguard and martial arts enthusiast who originates from Kosovo.
I do train myself in two levels, physically in a gym and martial arts, but martial arts helped me a lot psychologically, keeping me focus on what I'm doing. And this is the key that I will win it.
As a highly trained bodyguard, Emer is used to working long hours under high pressure. But can he cut it on the truck?
I was 17 and I needed to leave my country. It will make me stronger than the other contestants.
Or could it be contestant number 13, Mary Moore? Mary is a 40-year-old former casino croupier from Bristol who has a very unusual advantage over the other contestants.
I'm not going to do any training for the competition. All I need is some sleep the night before, hopefully.
Mary doesn't do gym, yoga or martial arts, and she's never won an endurance event. So why is she such a strong candidate for the truck?
I've been diagnosed as a pathological insomniac because there's no reason for me not to sleep, but I don't.
In fact, Mary claims to only sleep for 3 hours every 2 days, and she once stayed up for 9 days on the trot. Of course, it's more than just a five-horse race around the truck, but one of these hot favourites could well be in the driving seat when the rest of the contestants are on the bus home.
Fabulous. They look great, don't they? Now, we know you need a strong character and a strong will and, frankly, a strong bladder for Touch the Truck. But what is the physical and mental toll of a challenge such as this? Well, I'm joined by Dr. Honna Abachita, who's keeping a watchful eye on the contestants. Honna, good to see you.
Hi.
I'm just wondering, is this going to be easy? Because it sounds easy.
It looks easy, but no, it's not easy at all.
Really?
Yes.
What physically can go wrong, seriously speaking?
Well, physically, muscle pains, dehydration,
yeah.
Muscular aches and pains mainly.
Right, and mentally?
Mentally, hallucinations, poor coordination.
People are going to get hallucinations?
Yes, it's possible.
And do they last for a while? Do they come and they go? I mean,
they'll come and go. I mean, it will vary from different contestants, but it's, yes. They will.
What would your advice be to any contestant that's standing at the moment, say, to keep themselves going? What best medical advice could you give them?
The best medical advice, I think, is to eat regularly, high carbohydrates, to keep their blood sugar up, lots of fluids to prevent dehydration.
The diet's very important.
Yes, and a good mental attitude.
What about, the co-pilots? They're here to help them along the way.
Yes.
What advice would you say to the co-pilots? What should they be doing?
Keep the contestants happy, talk to them, encourage them. You know, do your best to keep them going, help them relax in their breaks, get them food, get them drinks when you can.
Will we still be sitting here in 5 days' time with 20 contestants, do you think?
I doubt it. This is going to be very difficult.
Really?
Hopefully as many as can will get through.
Brilliant. Well, thanks for now. As you can see, this really is a test of endurance. Of course, the will to win has our noble track record. People have been doing completely daft things to earn money for years. Have a look at this.
USA in the 1930s, ballroom dancing marathons offered a cash prize to the couple who could dance the longest, and desperate contestants danced for months until they finally dropped. By the 70s, those crazy Yanks had gotten into rocking chair marathons, with people rocking themselves non-stop for up to a week. These days, endurance seems to include almost every activity that you could possibly think of. American Richard Rodriguez holds the record for the world's longest roller coaster ride, having stayed on a Blackpool Big Dipper for a nauseating 83 days. But it's the prize of a motor vehicle which has really tested endurance enthusiasts, with competitions across Britain and the rest of the world inviting people to hold on to cars to win them. It's always taken a special kind of person to win this type of event, and the latest star of endurance is Brian Root from Alabama. Brian has won an incredible 16 vehicles, making him the most successful truck toucher in the world.
I love just the atmosphere, competing, the party atmosphere, and the truck all work together.
Fantastic. Fabulous. Well, I've been joined by the man with an amazing track record in endurance tests. Now, Brian Root has touched up more trucks than anybody else and has spent over 1,931 hours with his hands on trucks. That's over 80 days. No, keep awake, keep awake, keep awake. Let's get this straight. Did I get those facts and figures right?
That sounds pretty good. They told me I've been 80 days standing with my hand on a car, so
yeah.
I didn't know that until they told me.
And you've got a name for it now. You call it what? Handathons.
Yeah, I've heard handathon in America. That's what we call most of them.
If anybody asks you, would you say, I'm a professional? Is that what you describe yourself as?
I don't think so. I mean, I've done one here, one there, and over the years they've just added up. You know, I don't have sponsors or anything, so I don't know. I don't think so.
What about the side effects and the after effects? I mean, that is a heavy toll you put on yourself.
It's pretty rough, especially sleep-wise after the contest. I've gone like a month where every morning I'll wake up and think I have to keep my hand on something, on the bed or my body, thinking I'm still in the contest.
Really?
And sometimes it's only a week, sometimes a month, so that's tough.
That's a nightmare, really.
It really is.
A nightmare. What about attitude when you're doing the contest? You're obviously the expert, so what should they be doing?
Well, each person is different, but the tact I took was I knew that I was going to win the contest, so I wanted to help out everybody to have as good of experience of the contest as they could. So I would help people out.
So it's attitude.
It's attitude is a big
That's
part
an
of
attitude.
It.
Would you say you have a natural ability to do this? Is it something which you can, like, you're born with the patience to do this?
It must be something in my brain that's not working right that allows me to just kind of stand there and not think about something, you know, not think about everything.
How important is the co-pilot in all of this?
Very important. Yeah, I had a friend of mine in America that helped me on most of them, and he was there with me the whole time. I could always look out and see him out in the audience if I needed him, and it's good to have that constant support.
Were you ever let down by your co-pilot?
Yeah, my brother. I let my brother help me out one time, and he was chatting with this woman, and he forgot to look at his stopwatch, and I was laying down on the cot, and by the time he forgot, you know, he remembered I was there, it was too late, and I couldn't get back up.
You were taking one of the short breaks, and you missed your chance. How far into the contest were you?
Well, right after I got disqualified, an hour later, the last guy dropped out.
Oh, no.
So,
oh, dear. Well, you're going to stick around and watch the contest.
Definitely.
I do wish you well. I know you want to take part, but you're just an observer today. Right.
Thanks, Dave.
Well, I think I need to talk to more of our truck touchers. Let's go and say hello. Bill, you look a vision. What have you come as? What is all this about?
I'm me.
You are me, and you've got a lot of friends here.
Yeah.
Dressed from your...
under the Medieval Siege Society.
Right, I know, because it says you're a medieval battle reenactor. So are you going to use any medieval techniques to keep you going, or maybe put some of the other truck touchers off?
Well, I'm not going to say at this stage, but I've got a few siege tactics down my trousers, I would think.
Oh, have you, Bijou? Are you a driver?
I don't.
You don't? I suppose chariots are really more your thing, aren't they, really?
That's a bit before me.
A bit before you. Well, I just thought with the medieval thing, you'd be going for chariots.
Yeah.
Well, I wish you luck. Keep it going. Don't let take your hand. I'm so worried. Debbie, how are you doing?
Very well, thanks, Dale.
I shall chat to you a bit later. And our Jerry here, our eco-warrior. Are you holding up all right, Jerry?
Yeah, I think so. Glad to get started.
Good. I know. It's been a long day, hasn't it? And over here, finally... It is good to see. This is Christopher Robinson.
That's
great. Christopher Rainbow there. Now, you are ex-Foreign Legion, aren't you?
That's correct, yeah.
So you are Mr. Fit as you please, aren't you?
No, nutter.
A nutter. would you say something physical to get yourself ready for this?
Oh, yes. I've been doing a lot of physical, a lot of training in the gym. I've had a great gym that's helped me out. I've been doing my own training. My co-pilot's been pushing me. No, physically, very ready.
What about the sleep deprivation? Have you prepared yourself for the sleep deprivation?
Yes, I have. I've been knocking 20 minutes off every week while I've known about the show, and I got down to 2 hours 20 a night. But this last week, I've been totally relaxing my body and sleeping as much as possible.
So up until the last week, you've been sleeping less and less and
yeah,
less. But
correct.
This week, you've topped it all up
exactly.
again.
Exactly, my immune system and everything.
What about your co-pilot?
Yeah, Andy, great. I couldn't ask for a better co-pilot.
Yeah?
No, he's absolutely fantastic. He's given me all the support.
Well, see, the other thing about your co-pilot is, he said, winning isn't everything, it's the only thing.
Yeah, that's quite right.
Has he got the right attitude?
Oh, his attitude is totally that way. Yeah,
yeah.
Absolutely.
Good. Well, I wish you luck. I wish you all lots of luck. Let's wish them all lots of luck. Good luck, everybody. Brilliant. What you've just seen took place 6 hours ago, so So we're now well into the challenge. Now join us after the break to see if the hands of time have taken their toll on the hands of our 20 truckers. Don't go away. Welcome back. We're touching the truck live at Lakeside Thurrock. Well, 6 hours ago, these 20 contestants took their places around this truck. They're here to win this amazing prize worth over £30,000. All they have to do is keep one hand in contact with the truck till they're the last one standing. They're not allowed to sit, slump, or sleep. And our team of referees, touch judges, and medics are constantly monitoring them to make sure there is no infringement of the rules. And to keep our truckers focused on the task in hand, each of our contestants has a backup team, a co-pilot, either a friend or a relative, who's here to tickle their fancies as the hours pass by and give not only emotional but also physical support. We'll be meeting them a little later on. Now, here's the deal. Every 2 hours, our touchers are allowed a 10-minute breather to do whatever they want. Eat, sleep, or stretch their legs. Every 6 hours, they get a whopping 15-minute pit stop to pamper themselves. However, for the remaining 21 hours and 55 minutes a day, they stand as a band with a hand on 30 grand. So I wonder how they're holding up. Let's find out. Sebastian, don't take your hand off the truck. You're stroking it. Is that because it's going to be yours?
This is going to be my baby.
Is it? Now, your slogan is, and I will quote you correctly, your slogan is, do what you have to do. Is that going to see you through?
That's going to see me through.
Now, I know that one of your passions is cooking and entertaining. You're going to be doing none of that. But I guess this is a bit like, is this like a dinner party for 20 for you?
Yeah, this is going to be our own little private party.
And you'll be the last one serving?
Definitely.
Definitely. Well, I wish you luck. It's good to see
Thank
you.
Thank you very much.
You're next to Adam, who you've been with, well, for 6 hours now. Adam, you are fit as a fiddle because you're a trained boxer, isn't that right?
Yeah, that's right.
Absolutely. So, and you brought your supporters along. Now, I know that you're used to having your gloves on. Not those kind of gloves, but are you finding this easy going at the moment?
So far. It's early days, but...
Mm-hmm. What do you think it is that will stand you in good stead? Is it physical fitness or is it the mental attitude?
Mental.
His co-pilot shouting at the back there. Oh, so I remember your co-pilot. We're chatting to him a bit later on. Well, I wish you luck, Adam.
Thank you.
Standing next to Pam. Hi, Pam.
Hi.
Now, you love off-roaders, so this must be your dream, really, mustn't it, really?
Definite dream.
Now, what do you think is your best and strongest quality about keeping that hand on that truck?
It has to be the fact that I like a challenge and there's no way I'm going to give up straight away.
Now, how are you getting on with Adam?
He's cool.
He's cool. I mean, you're facing him at the moment.
Yeah.
So, you've got someone behind you, so I'll have a quick chat to Colin. How are you doing, Colin?
Wicked.
Very quickly, Colin, I have to tell you, this man, what this man has done, this man has soaked his feet in vinegar. Now, why have you done that?
To toughen up the bottom of my feet.
Is it working?
Yep, so far.
Are you in good shape at the moment?
Certainly am.
Excellent. Well, I wish you luck. Colin, well done, well done, well. Over the next days and nights, we'll be getting to know this lot pretty well. Now, for you at home, here's a head start. Have a look.
Tim Ashby is a 57-year-old car delivery driver from Oxford. His main motivation is to outlast the record for truck touching held by American Warren Hearn in a record time of over 125 hours and 30 minutes.
I never touch the truck because I know psychologically and mentally I'm very strong. I know I can beat the other people.
Tim has prepared carefully for the event, paying meticulous attention to detail.
We've been to check out the Lakeside Centre. We've timed ourselves going to the toilets, how long it takes going up by lift, how long it takes by going by escalator. We're fully familiar with the area.
Tim will wear a shirt and tie on day one, go open neck shirt on day three, until finally on day four he's going to go casual. He's also invented a surreal secret language with his co-pilot's son to keep their communications clandestine during the competition.
So how are you feeling?
Fruit salad.
Sure you don't want Murray Mint?
Possibly tomato soup.
Tomato soup it'll be then.
Tim has a poem which he's lived his life by. He feels that it would help him during Touch the Truck.
If you think you'll lose, you've lost. For out in the world you'll find. Success begins with a fellow's will. It's all in the state of mind.
So Sophie Bracca is a 30-year-old salsa teacher from Primrose Hill in London. She's taken an altogether more spiritual approach to her preparations for the truck.
I think I'm going to win because I've prepared myself on all levels. On a physical level with my diet and exercise, on a mental level with mind over matter techniques, and on a spiritual level I'm going to be in touch with my higher power.
Sophie has been using a pair of special mind goggles to get into the right mental shape. She's also visited a nutritionist, a personal trainer, and is taking special touching classes from Andrew, a life strategist guru.
Stay.
Sophie is learning a technique which she is convinced will give her an edge over the other competitors.
Andrew's designed a bubble for me, and I will stay inside the bubble completely calm and relaxed and not affected by any outside influences.
Fantastic, fantastic. Well, if you've just joined us, we're live from Lakeside Thurrock for Touch the Truck. And I'm here with Brian Root, our expert in endurance, who so far has won vehicles worth over $160,000. So to them, you are like a hero, really, aren't you, Brian? So, I mean, looking at them, how does this differ from the contest in America?
It's actually pretty similar. You have similar rules here. This one's indoors, where most of ours are outdoors under a tent.
Oh,
so
really?
It's a little bit easier.
What,
here
in a hot area of America? Or?
Oh, usually in like Florida, South Florida, where it's 110 degrees and high humidity.
So how do you think that is going to affect our touches here? Is it going to make it easier being indoors?
I think it's going to be a little tougher, actually, because they're going to be lulled into a little sleep pattern there. You know, it's going to be too easy for them, I think, maybe.
And how long do you reckon you could last?
I could go as long as it takes to beat any of these guys here, I think.
Well, I know that, because look... No, because they all think they're going to win. Looking at you, I've been watching you throughout the day, and to be fair, Brian, I've kind of felt you wanted to touch the truck yourself.
I have been kind of leaning towards going in there. Yeah,
You'd love to do it, wouldn't you?
Sure,
you'd love to do it.
Sure.
Okay, now, this is... Guys and girls, I'm going to have to say this, and you're going to hear me say this. You've had a good look at all of them. Are there any here you could like say who's going to win or not? Who do you think favorite?
Well, there's a couple guys here that are big muscle guys, and that doesn't always win the contest. I see a couple older guy, an older guy here that's pretty balanced, and I think he... I'm kind of pulling
for
him.
Well, we'll have more from you a bit later. Well, have any of our truckers got what it takes to be another Brian Root? Let's see.
Bobby Shaw is a 27-year-old city slicker. A risk analyst for an international bank, he's not short of cash, so why does he want to touch the truck?
I'm very competitive. I always like to come in first position. I never come in any other position, and I know I'm going to win this.
Bobby's friends in the city have been gambling thousands of pounds on him winning.
Now, I've told them, as I'm a risk analyst, if you want to win, the best way to do it is to bet on me. And there's a lot of high stakes going on.
And to ensure they don't lose, his boss has forced him to offer his resignation if he doesn't come back with the truck. Jimmy Trott is 42 years old and homeless. Originally from Hull, Jimmy has been living in the streets and hostels of London for the last 6 years.
When it's raining, you get wet. When it's snowing, you get snow on you. When it's windy, you get really cold. But there is some nice people up there who do help you up now and again.
Jimmy's co-pilot is Len, a fellow resident and mate from his homeless hostel. Len and Jimmy like hanging out watching cars drive past, although neither of them has ever owned a car worth more than £150.
I'm going to win Touch the Truck because I've never won anything before in my life. So watch out, contestants. This truck is mine. And nobody, repeat, nobody is going to beat me to it.
That has just signaled the start of the first 50-minute pit spot. So, you know who you are. Off you go for your first break. Off you go. Over the next hour, all 20 truckers will have a 15-minute break to do whatever they need to do. Freshen up, lie down, sit, shave or shower. I said sit, shave or shower. The first group of five is on their way to the pits to get a pep talk and be pampered by their co-pilots. Now, I'll be joining them a bit later on. In the meantime, I'm standing here with the remaining 15 who can't wait to crash. So, let's talk to some more touchers. Uma! Welcome to Touch the Truck. How are you doing, Uma?
I'm doing well.
Now, I know that, you know, you've been getting ready for this with a bit of, is it Aikido?
Yeah, Aikido, it's my favorite sport, and I'm doing for a long time, for 8 years. It's martial art.
Well, I saw you doing the high kicks.
Really, no, but just karate when I was six. I used to do it, and I just done for a show.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I've got to ask you this. Why do you want to do this? I mean, I know you want to win the truck, but there are easier things to do in this world.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. But I want to put like 20 or 15 grand to my daughter's account, and when she gets to my age, she can study wherever she wants, or she have enough money.
Well, as I say to all the others, I wish you luck.
Thank you very much. Thanks.
Bobby.
Hi.
To be fair, you don't need to win a truck, do you? I've just seen you signing your life away from the job in the city. Now, what is going on? What's all that about?
Well, my boss says if you really want something, you've got to put something on the line for it. Mm-hmm. So I've signed a contract saying if I lose, I automatically resign.
Oh, are you kidding?
No.
For real?
Yeah.
What have you been doing to get ready for this? Have you been training?
Not much training, but there's a few things that I have on my sleeve.
Little tactics. Yeah. We'll be seeing those a bit later. Wendy! Says here, I know all about you. Hates olives, scared of the sea and petrified of mice.
It's absolutely not true.
How are you in shopping malls?
Absolutely fine.
Good, okay.
Give me anything to dangle from and I'll be fine.
Oh, indeed. I'll talk to you later. Well, how many of our plucky truckers will want to come back after having a breather? It's all down to their will to win. Have a look at this.
Adam Giorgio is a 31-year-old London cabbie. Adam has a good reason to believe that he will win the truck.
I'm going to win this competition because I'm very competitive. I love a challenge. I've won everything else I've been in for, so I'm going to win this.
Adam's friends call him Agony Ad because his passengers always end up telling him about their problems. Adam says that women passengers in particular tend to take a shine to him.
I think driving a taxi round is quite attractive to women. Well, down from experience, I found, anyway. I don't know what to say about that. I'm not sure how to word it.
So it's no surprise what Adam will do with the truck.
I'd like to win a truck because it'd be nice to pick up my girlfriends in something rather than my taxi, because I've always got to sit in the back. It'd be nice to have them sitting in the front with me. We can talk.
Paul Sinclair is a 35-year-old part-time motorcycle courier from Glasgow. But like your average biker, in his spare time, Paul is the pastor of an evangelical church.
When I'm holding on to that truck, I'll tell you, I'm going to be on a mission from God. To be honest, I've done virtually no training whatsoever. So the only thing I've done is try to get my heart right, my spirit right, and get people praying for me.
So with his congregation on his side, not to mention God, surely Paul can't lose. Church members have been helping out by keeping their hands on the preacher, and they've even written him a song. Paul isn't just going to touch the truck, he's hoping to touch some of the contestants
as well. Well, 6 hours into the challenge and the pressure's really on. Now, to get an idea of the toll this contest is taking on our truck touchers, Dr. Honor is back taking their blood pressure. So, oh my goodness, this looks very technical. Now, tell me, how important to start with is the blood pressure?
Absolutely crucial. It's a very good indication of how healthy each trucker is and continuing to be.
Right. What would you say if suddenly the blood pressure went really... would you say, hang on a minute?
Yes, I'm looking out for very high blood pressure, very low blood pressure, and obviously that would be something to be concerned about.
Now, obviously, the guys and girls here who are hoping to win the truck probably think, well, maybe I need to drink a lot of coffee in my breaks. If I'm a smoker, well, smoking is the second highest stimulant, isn't it, after coffee? What do you think? Is that going to help?
I'm not advising anyone to take any caffeine because it dehydrates people. It's called a diuretic, and that means it will encourage your body to get rid of all your fluid, which you don't
want. Right. What would you recommend very quickly to do in their break? Massage?
Massage, drinking lots of fluids, Just try and stay cheerful, I think.
Fantastic. Well, we're all cheerful here. Well, after the break, I'll be joining the competitors for their pit stop. I'll be seeing what they think of each other and if they prefer having their feet up to having their hands on. Oh, and don't forget, you can watch them bleary-eyed live at any hour of the day or night. All you need to do is just log on to the Channel 5 website and see the action unfold as it happens. Stay in touch. And their first pit stop. Now, this is Debbie and husband Kevin. Debbie, what was the priority for you? You're standing at the truck. What's the priority for you for your first break?
Food.
Food?
Food.
Now, hubby here is helping you doing your break, isn't he? He's your,
yes.
He's your co-pilot.
Yeah.
But an unlucky fellow. He's been through it all in the last year or so. I mean, is he the right man for the job? I mean, what have I got here? Hernias, double pneumonia, been run over. He's broken his legs. He's all right now. Good. Broken arm, broken both ankles and been knocked out. This is the man that's going to see you through.
He's seen me through everything else. I'll put my money on him.
You put your money... And how are you feeling at the moment?
Fine. Absolutely fine.
Anybody that you're standing nearby, you're thinking, I'm not sure about this one?
No, actually, no? Everybody's
happy?
Doing really well.
Well,
nice
enjoy
lunch.
Your break. I'm going to chat to the others. Enjoy your break. Oh, my goodness. Well, here we have... Our ex, well, army bloke, I was going to say, really.
Yeah.
Christopher, what are you doing?
Well, it's what the lads would expect, going out and drag.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, look at my friends. These all blokes.
Oh, are they?
No.
This is turning into a Jerry Springer show, it really is. Smoking, you're a big smoker. You've got the fags on and you're eating chocolate. Is this a tactic?
No, I'm just munching.
Just munching?
Yeah.
You seem very confident, not having a problem with this yet, are you?
No, not at all.
Yeah?
I'm in laugh. That's
and your co-pilot's here.
Hello there.
Any special... Eventually, has he been a bit lacking for
no,
you?
No, he's been very good, very good.
And what do you reckon his chances of staying the odds?
They're very good. He looks in good nick at the moment. Look at him.
Now, I did hear that you got drunk last night. I wouldn't have thought this was the... You got absolutely plastered. The last night before you go without sleep, is this a good idea?
I had some sleeping taxi on the way home. And we blew all our money.
Is that it?
I got peanuts and chocolate.
I don't think he's going to be here for long, but I do wish him well. Oh! Sylvester!
Hello, Phil.
Your odds on at the moment. You're doing pretty good.
Really?
Right.
Well,
but I have to say, it looks a bit lonely in here. You've got some orange drink. Is that it?
That's going to be it.
You've eaten already?
I've eaten. I've been to the loo.
What were you looking forward to in this, your first pit stop?
Rest on my feet, off
really?
My feet, yeah.
But you're used to running marathons and all sorts.
That's very true, yeah. That came with a lot of pain and illness, but in this particular challenge, it's a lot. There's no comparison because you're standing still.
Are you going to win the truck?
I'm going to win the truck. But before you go,
yeah.
I love your suit and tie. It's absolutely wicked.
I tell you what, if you're the last man standing, yeah. I'll give you the suit.
Thank you very much.
I promise you.
Yeah?
I promise you. Good luck, Sylvester. Oh, I see. We're having a bit of a wipe down here. First bit of good hygiene I've seen. Pam and friend Joy.
Hi.
Looking good, Pam?
Feeling good.
So, as I say, eating chocolate, and you're absolutely right. Now, is this a determined tactic? That's all I'm going to eat for 5 days?
Oh, no, no. I've actually just had a roll, a chicken and bacon roll.
Yeah.
Didn't fancy it, but it's cool.
How are you getting on with all the other guys?
They're actually... Everyone's quite happy at the moment, so it'll be tomorrow.
Co-pilot, you know her really, really well. What is going to be her downfall? What's going to be her weakness if anything is going to let her down? What will it be?
She'll laugh and take her hand off the truck.
She'll laugh and take her hand off the truck?
Yeah, she'll just go, "Ugh!"
Oh, really?
Yeah.
How long do you give her?
She'll make it to the end.
She will, won't she?
Yeah,
well,
she
you know, I wish you luck. Well done, Pam!
Yay!
And finally...
Hey!
David, you never thought I was going to get you. David and Kelvin here. And then the cupboard was bare. There isn't any food.
Yes, it is, mate.
Food down there. You've got a fag on.
Fag going.
So tell me, how are you feeling right now?
Oh, I'm relaxed and calm, Dill, yeah. Doing great, mate.
Strategy?
Strategy. Later on, I'm going to psych them out.
Really?
Yeah, I've already...
You're going to psych them out? How are you going to do that?
Just stare at them, Dill, and just give them,
really?
Just give them the evil eye, Dill.
How long have you two guys known each other?
21 years.
21 years.
Yeah.
So, one question. Are you going to be the last man standing?
We're going to be the last man standing, Dill. And It's a good thing, really. I brought Kelvin along with me. As you know, he's a mechanic.
Yeah.
And he's here for one simple reason. If I have a nervous breakdown, he's there to help.
Oh, is he? All right, fair enough.
Is that
one question. How are you coping without the cigarettes? Because you can only smoke in your breaks.
Oh, it's not too bad.
Are you getting a rush? Because it does give you a bit of a rush.
No, not really. They'll just take it in a stride.
You're quite laid back from someone, really.
Well,
you know.
Those Yorkshire lads, you know what we like.
Good Yorkshire stock. Good Yorkshire stock.
From Somerset, by the way.
Well, I wish you luck. Good luck, David. Kelvin, OK. We've taken betting odds on all of these. Who's even Stevens and who's got the best odds? Let's have a look.
On the outside of the field are Sophie Bracca and Pam Hardy at 33-1, as well as Adam Giorgio and Debbie Stinchcombe. At 25-1 is Wendy Hesketh, Kay Rigby, Mary Moore and Colin Caffrey. Moving up, we've got Bill Curd and Bobby Shaw at 22-1. At 16-1, we've got Davinia McFarlane, Sylvester John, while at 14-1, it's Jason Crump. Paul Sinclair is at 12-1, while at 10-1, it's David Guest. In at 7, it's Jimmy Trott. Second favourites at 5-1 are Tim Ashby, Jerry Middleton, Emer Abdullahu, but out in front at 4-1, the favourite by a nose is Christopher Robinson. 20 runners, but no odds on favourite. The race is on.
Fabulous, fabulous. Paul, I haven't really spoken to you properly yet. One question, you've had your break. What did you do on your break?
On this break, I just ate something very, very light. I'm on a partial fast, keeps you sharper, so I just eat something in it later in the day.
Good. Later in the day, in the middle of the night, maybe. Yep. I wish you luck, Paul. Well, it'll be some time before our touchers are entering the home straight, and we'll be here until someone wins this truck. But that's it for the moment. Why don't you join me tomorrow? And in the meantime, log on to the Channel 5 website at any time, day or night, to see our plucky truckers. Don't forget, it's what your right hand's for. Stay in touch. Average show public have met a film star or pop star, everyone.
Yeah, it's no
big deal.
How
many people have met a Legionnaire? None of them. And in my own way, I am all famous and I'm a rarity.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's given me a lot of confidence.
Yeah, absolutely.
Live from Lakeside Thurrock, it's the man who can give a truck. Please welcome your host, Dale Winton.
Great. Thank you, thank you. Good evening. Welcome back to Lakeside Thurrock, where we are now 30 hours into what could become a world record-breaking endurance challenge. That's right, it's 30 hours since our 20 contestants first laid hands on what will eventually will win. This is this fabulous 4x4 off-roader, which is worth well over £30,000. Now, to win this Toyota truck, all our touchers have to do is keep one hand in contact with it at all times. Quite simply, the one that survives drives. Now, it sounds easy, but when I tell you that they can't sit or sleep on the job, you'll begin to realize that this really is a feat of mind over matter, and their state of mind is what matters. You know, the longer our contestants go without sleep, the more likely they are to lose touch, not only with reality, but also with the truck. Now, the moment they remove their hands, our team of referees and touch judges will terminate them. In other words, they will have well and truly trucked themselves. Obviously, we have 24-hour medical support for all our contestants. Now, I can tell you at this point in time, one of our touchers has fallen by the wayside. We'll be finding out who in just a moment, but first, let me tell you that they all started out yesterday afternoon convinced that they would be driving this dream away. But they didn't take into account the excruciating pain on the one hand and the mind-numbing boredom on the other. But on Touch the Truck, it's the one hand that counts. Now, if you haven't been able to log on to the Channel 5 website and follow the action live, you won't have seen the first contestant walk away. It's fabulous. Have a look at this.
How hard can it be to keep one hand on a truck? Well, 15 hours into the competition at 5:38 this morning, contestant number 3, Sophie Bracca, lost her concentration for only 2 seconds. Contestant 20, Jimmy Trott, carelessly left his water bottle under her feet and Sophie kicked it over.
Ah!
Let's see that again.
Ah!
And again. Sophie looks to the referees, hoping she's got away with it. But unfortunately, she's been caught out on every camera.
Who? Who?
Camera.
Really? It's an accident. It was an accident.
While the referees look at the video playback, Sophie has a tense conversation with the man who's been by her side since 2 o'clock yesterday afternoon.
Stop psyching me out. I thought you were on my side. I thought you were a friend.
Not psyching you out.
Just keep your gob shut and shut
I'm
up about
girl.
It. What, you were my friend? Nobody's a friend here.
But video playback confirms the referee's decision, and it's time to go.
Due to an early retrenchment, it's been backed up with video evidence. You did remove your hand from the truck. You have no option but to disqualify it. And I'll have to keep coming in.
Can I just explain the reason why I had an accident with the bottle? Can I say something?
We can talk about it.
Can I just say something about the bottle? Yeah. I had my bottle there, right? I had it there, and Jimmy knocked it over, so I moved it over there.
Well,
and then I tripped
it
over
does stay, it. Under any circumstances, you're not to remove the head from the truck. You did remove the head from the truck. There's no evidence to back it up.
Right.
And that's what I said.
Okay,
can I?
Unsurprisingly, having touched the truck from Sunday afternoon to early Monday morning, Sophie is not exactly delighted to find out that she's been disqualified.
I'm upset, obviously.
Yeah, I'm angry.
Yeah, I'm upset.
Because it was an accident.
Yeah. I momentarily tripped over it, and at that point I did move around the truck. Whether my hand, for how many seconds, left, during that trip, but it must have been like a second.
Ooh. Wow, that was great. Wasn't that great? Well, sorry, Sophie, but I'm standing right where Sophie was standing. Now, Jimmy, what was the fracas with Sophie Bracca all about? I mean, quite clearly, having looked at that videotape today, she blames you for her downfall. Your side of the story.
Well, she had a bottle in front of her and she kept kicking it over herself and put it behind her. And then what she wanted to do, move back and kicked it down. And she kicked it down the stairs. Tim, who was in front of me, went down to pick it up. Said, leave it, in a real nasty voice.
Oh.
And she went down and picked it up herself. That's when she must have took her hands off the truck.
Are you going to miss her?
No, I'm not.
Oh. Would I be right in saying you're quite glad to see the back of Sophie?
Yes, sir.
How were you getting on when you were standing close together, apart from that?
Well, she kept coming on to people, trying to get friendly with people.
Coming on to people? Yeah, Do you mean like...
She was trying to get me to... Well, she asked the other contestants to set down the truck so I could win it. And I didn't want that. I want to win it fair and square.
Oh, dear.
She asked them all to say, Come on, let's all take our hands off the truck, Stuart, and we can win it.
Do you think you're the only one around the truck that's glad to see the back of her?
I think most of them are glad to see the back of her.
Okay, well, I quite like her. She's a lovely girl. But then I'm not standing with her 24 hours a day. Continued good luck, Jimmy. You're doing brilliantly. Now, Uma,
yeah.
I need to talk to you about... you had a medical check earlier today.
Yeah.
A bit of blood pressure. What's going on there?
Today, not actually. Today, it was okay. But yesterday, just on the beginning, it was first the blood pressure, it was too low. After that, it was too high. And you're just going, getting high and down and high.
Well, that's the thing you see on Touch the Truck. It's all very well to keep an eye on you, but we need to make sure that it's all right in here. So we care for you.
Yeah.
I have to say, you're not looking as bright and bubbly. You don't look as well as you did yesterday. You feeling okay?
Yeah.
Sure about? I'm not trying to psych you out. I just thought you do look, I'm not too sure. You look like, we'll see a bit later. So
yeah. We've
lost the one who fell at the first fence. Let's see how the bookies rate the remaining 19.
It's all changed today with our female contestants trailing the field, Kay Rigby, Wendy Hesketh, Pam Hardy and Debbie Stinchcombe are all at 33-1. Our London cabbie Adam Giorgio is at 25-1, while medieval battle reenactor Bill Curd hangs out with city slicker Bobby Shaw at 22-1. Colin Caffrey and super fit gym instructor Davinia McFarlane are 20-1. At 16-1, it's Sylvester John. Next up, contestant number 18, Paul Sinclair, at 14-1. Our astral projecting roofer, David Guest, is at 12-1. And now at the top of the field, really hots up, Mary Moore, Jason Crump, and Jimmy Trott all come in at 10-1. At 6-1, it's Jerry Middleton. Emer Abdullahu is at 5-1. And tough guy, Christopher Robinson, is at 4-1. But he's taken a back seat to 57-year-old shirt and tie man, quietly confident and fully prepared. It's our new favourite, Tim Ashby, at 3-1.
Who's your favourite to win? I wonder. I'm keep on changing my mind. But I'm here with a man who probably has a good idea. It's Brian Root, who's our expert in endurance. You've won 16 of these competitions, so you know exactly what you're doing. Now, you've been in America, it's slightly different over here, but you've had a good look at everybody. Brian, tell me, who is your favorite at the moment?
Well, I've got Tim picked, the older guy.
Oh,
but,
really?
Yeah, but he's a little bit older, but he's balanced the whole time. He's kind of calm. He doesn't have the highs, he doesn't have the lows. And he has a good mindset.
He's loosening up a bit because the tie's gone. He said, I'm going to do this with a tie. The tie's gone. What else will go, I wonder? You know, we started with 20. We're now down to 19. How does that affect the remaining touches that one has gone now? I mean, does that psychologically play any games with you?
It's very good, actually, because you're up until that point, you're thinking, wait a minute, nobody's dropped out. Maybe they're all going to go 5 days and, you know, we'll be here 9 days. So as soon as one drops out, it's a big relief and a boost.
Does that signal a chain of events, like one's gone, there could be another three or four ready to go?
I think so. A lot of people are waiting. If they're hurting really bad, they're thinking, I'm not going to be the first one out. And then as soon as one goes, they may think a little bit later, oh, maybe I'm going to give up.
Yeah. They're all in good humor.
Yes.
And they're looking good. I'm wondering about diet now. At this stage, they've had a day or so at it. What should they be looking at in terms of what they're eating?
Well, in most of my contests, I would eat basically just fruit the whole time.
Sugar, yeah. Fresh sugar and fruit.
Yeah. Well, just apples, oranges, bananas, dates, whatever kind of fruit I get my hand on. And I think that's the best because it doesn't really take digestion. You eat it and it just goes right through and it gives more energy for staying awake.
Well, they've already started to experience the pit stops now. They've had the 10-minute break, the 15. What should they be doing now in a pit stop?
I think the best thing right now, especially, is lay down, put your feet up, and let your co-pilot massage your feet and get the blood going back up to the head.
Co-pilot's very important,
definitely,
as we're about to see. Now, you wouldn't think you could lose by a trip to the loo. Nearly happened to one of our players. Have a look at this.
Even truck touchers need to visit the loo, and every 2 hours they're given 10 minutes to do just that. So when the whistle blows, the race is on.
Hands on 1 minute!
But in his first break, contestant number 10, Sylvester John, didn't keep his eyes on the clock and only just made it back to the truck in time. Being caught short had almost caught him out.
If he had got thrown, I'd throttle him because it's too early for anybody to give up. And the technicality is going to the loo. I think I'll get enough before him next time.
It's break number 2, and Sylvester has learned his lesson. He takes off like a rocket, tears away from the truck, racing in the direction of the loos, and is back in time to gobble down some food.
When did you decide that you wanted to go to the loo? You know, was it that sort of last minute thing?
Last minute thing, yeah.
And did you panic when you got back to the car?
A little bit.
What's the atmosphere up there like?
Everyone's in good spirit. Excuse me while I'm eating.
The marathon runner is hot-footing it again and is so fast this time that he may have broken a record. He took just 5 of his 10-minute break. So while other contestants take it easy at break time, Sylvester's narrow escape has him taking no chances.
Well, that was hard.
Brilliant. Well, that was a very close call. Now, Tim is standing next to me. Tim, has that ever happened to you in your break?
Definitely not. Not with my co-pilot, no.
No. That's it. He's been great, hasn't he?
Fantastic. Fantastic. Yep.
Tell me something. Anybody getting on your nerves at the moment? Are you coping all right?
Yeah, coping fine. Yep.
No one driving you slightly
nuts? No one driving me really mad, no.
Are you weakening?
No, definitely not.
You've taken off the tie and you said to me, Dale, I'm going to do it with the tie, but the whole thing, you're beginning to...
It's part of the game plan. Part of the game plan.
Oh, it's psyching them all out, making them think that maybe...
As the days unfold, you'll see.
Have you been enjoying your pit stops?
Yeah, thoroughly.
Do you really,
yeah.
really...
Yeah, having a really
cherish
good time.
Them.
Yeah,
you
having
do.
A really good...
Well,
yeah.
It's good to see
you.
Continued luck.
Will do.
I know
Take
I must
up.
Go and have a word with Colin down here. I have to say, Colin... I was nearly the reason for your downfall today.
You certainly were.
I really were. We were. Let me explain to everybody at home. We were rehearsing the show, and I said, well, they're going to ask you to turn round here. And you turned round, and I went, oh, my goodness, it's my fault. You've took your hand off the truck. But fortunately, we checked with the other guys. They said, it's cool. It was my fault. I am sorry. And
Top
you
thing.
Were such a gentleman. He was such a gentleman. You turned around and said, oh, I'm out. Yeah. You weren't out. It was my fault. How are you coping?
Sweet.
Yesterday, you were telling me you soaked your feet in vinegar.
That's right.
For what reason again?
To toughen up the bottom of my feet.
And is it working?
It certainly is.
Is there anything else that you're doing at the moment which like you particularly think you should be doing in the pit stops?
Just eating well.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You've got a big team of supporters here, haven't you?
I certainly have.
are they here all the time? Because I come and go and I sort of like...
They come in dribs and drabs, mainly over my time.
I'm waiting for a whistle because I think we're about to have the whistle because we've got some going off their break in a minute, aren't they? We're about a few seconds away from the whistle going, so you know, up. And there it is. That whistle signals the start of the pit stop for 5 of our lucky truckers. I'll be catching up with them later to see if they're sitting pretty or if they're ready to shove the glove. Now, if you're betting at home on who's going to win, you can always watch Round the Clock live on the Channel 5 website. In the meantime, stay in touch. I'll be right back after the break. Welcome back. Oh, it's so good to be here. I'm with Brian, our champion touch trucker, who's been keeping a close eye on all our touches. So, how are they doing?
Well, actually, I've got some notes, Dale.
Great, you go for it.
Yeah, well, I guess I can go for the ones I think are going to maybe drop out first.
I'd love to hear. They'd love to hear who you think
sure.
is going to drop out
well,
first.
Well, I think Jimmy, the homeless guy.
Oh, really?
He's, you know, he really probably wants to win a lot, but he's leaning a lot on the truck already. I've kind of seen, I mean,
really?
Leaning up against it. I don't know, the judges haven't seen it. And he's kind of a little scatterbrained, I think, which
he could He might be doing a bit better because he wasn't getting on terribly well with Sophie,
right,
was he?
Yeah.
Anybody else?
I think Jason, the tall basketball player.
Right.
He's got problems with his knees.
Right.
And I think that may be a big, a lot of pain for him. He may not be able to handle it.
Are we at the stage now where some of our truck touchers may be hallucinating a bit because the sleep deprivation?
They've probably gone through just a couple seconds of it here and there, but nothing major yet.
It's on the way.
Yeah, it's on the way, definitely.
Okay. What would you be doing yourself now to maybe put people off, help yourself win? Any tactics you'd be employing right now?
That's not my style, really. I mean, when I do contests, I actually try to help people out just because I know I'm going to win it, and I want them to have as good a time competing as they can because I have a good time doing it, and if I see that they're hurting, I want to help them get through that.
Having watched our 19, I was going to say 20, our 19 remaining touch truckers, have you seen any foul play? Think, oh, that's naughty. That's wicked. That really is going to put people off.
I haven't seen that yet, but I'm sure it'll happen.
Not having been to the States to see it in America, what surprised me here is that everybody's so friendly. They're getting on so well that when I walked back here to the mall this afternoon, everybody was like, "Hi, Dale. How are you?" They're in such good. I'd be going, "I've had no sleep. I've had enough. I want to go home. This is it. Please, I want to go home now."
You want to come back?
I would be like that. They're not.
Come back at about 2 or 3 in the morning.
Really?
You'll see that. Yeah.
In the dark hours.
Yes. When they're usually sleeping.
Okay, well,
cranky.
You look bright-eyed and bushy-tailed, and dare I say so to our contestants. Thank you, Brian.
You're welcome.
This is fascinating stuff. Now, the shoppers here at Lakeside absolutely agree with me. Have a look.
Tim, you will win!
We're going to be supporting him by cheering him on. We've got the T-shirts on. We're going to yell as loud as we can, and we're going to put the others off.
I think Dave's going to win because we're so tall, he's got more of an advantage. He doesn't have to hold his hand up so high and just lean on it.
One truck, one field, one truck, one field.
If the other contestants see us walking around with swords and armour on, then they're obviously going to be scared off.
I think the man, number 12, with a scarf on his head might win because he looks the type that would. He's out to get a car.
This is the best bit. This is the pit stop. Oh, look, to be so pampered. Paul, how are you doing?
I'm all right, but I'm in a bit of pain. I'm not being pampered, I'm being nursed.
It says, I'm told you've been injured. Tell me what happened.
I've obviously picked the wrong shoes to wear, and they're a bit tight, and my foot's completely swollen up and part of my leg. So try to get that back down so as I can get that truck.
Yeah, you're going to get the truck?
Of course.
Have you bonded with any other members of the teams?
Everyone gets on like a house on fire, really do. At first it was a wee bit awkward, but now it was just fantastic. And we have joke-telling competitions, some people are singing, all sorts of stuff. It's really good.
What is the worst time of the day or night for you? The time where you think, when my resolve maybe is like, maybe I'll give it up?
To be honest, for me, I've only even thought about that when my foot went wacky. I can't afford to think about giving it up.
Well, I'm not going to neg you out. I wish you continued success. Mike is massaging your leg. I'll see you later. See you later. Whoa, and who have we got here? Oh, more massaging going on. This is great. Now, Davina, what have you got? How are you doing, doll?
Good, yeah.
You look fit. You look well. What's going on down here with your feet?
Just having a little bit of reflexology here. It's just stimulating my head and just getting me alert, making me feel alive and active.
I have to say, you do look as fresh as a daisy. You look fantastic.
I feel great with a wonderful co-pilot like this, my uncle.
Your uncle is looking after you. Is that the secret of your success?
Most definitely, yeah. This is my success.
Okay. And Uncle Ian is here. Is Uncle Ian wilting at all? Because he looks like fresh as a daisy too.
Yeah, he is. I don't know how he's doing it because he's just at my beck and call 24/7.
How are you getting on with the other team members?
Yeah, good. Great at the moment. We're having
anybody involved. You'd like me to remove?
Not at the moment.
Just Adam, you want Adam? Uncle Ian saying Adam. Why is that, do you think?
He's
looking too good.
Yeah.
He's looking too good, is he?
He's a bit smooth.
Yeah. Is he really?
Yeah.
Uncle Ian says he's a bit sly. Yeah. Well, I don't know. Any tactics now?
We're just sticking to our game plan.
Well, I just asked Paul, and he said to me, he's only faltered once where he nearly gave up. I wondered what it's like in the wee small hours. Is that when you might think, I could do with having a good kick?
Well, we all think about having a nice little kip, don't we? But we know if, you know, if we want this car, then we've just got to keep on going. King.
Are you going to have the car?
Oh, most definitely, yeah.
Love it. I wish you luck, Davinia. I do wish you luck. Oh, they're all lying down. I don't blame them at all. Hi, darling. Hi, Wendy. I shall come down to you. How are you, Wendy?
Just fine, thank you.
Now, you seem okay. Anything I can do for you? Anything that needs help here?
No.
You're not lacking anything?
No, I'm absolutely fine. In fact, I'm feeling really motivated. Please, can I take this opportunity to say hi, Bushy Meads? Okay. I shall be teaching there tomorrow. So sorry to have let you down,
no, you're gonna
but
be
I'm here
till
instead.
The end, aren't you?
Yes.
How are you getting on with the rest of the crew?
What, around the car?
Absolutely.
We're a complete family, Dale. None of us are going home. We're all taking a bit of the car with us.
How can I put this delicately? You got quite friendly in the wee small hours with one of our truck touchers, didn't you?
Are you on about Chris? There's a rumour. It's actually on the internet as well that, like, me and Chris are the new hot romance.
And is this not true?
No, he's a fruit and nut bar.
Is he really?
Yes.
Is he not your kind of guy?
He's exactly my kind of guy. The one that needs to keep me awake and me to keep him awake. We are a perfect match for this game.
Well, maybe I'm not talking about him. Maybe I'm not talking about him. I want to see. We have a little tape of what happened in the wee small hours. Have a look at this.
What you want to do after the first 6 hour break, when you go to the loo, have they just check the colour of your urine. If it's too yellow, that means you're not taking enough water, you're getting dehydrated,
right.
Okay?
Yeah.
So just check its normal colour.
All right.
Right. How much is it worth if I don't get my ear down
your... Your ear
my
down
tongue.
My tongue?
No, my tongue down your ear now, though.
No, that just wouldn't be...
I wouldn't be well, so
but
nice.
But thanks, anyway. He's keeping me awake with all his... his finars. He's just very funny, you know.
I think it's a bit unfair for the other girls in this thing, though. They should all have a chance to be able to chat me up, shouldn't they?
Yeah, I think
they're
it's
really
unfair
sorry
that
for
I'm the chosen one, but yeah. I think they've kind of looked around and sort of...
I just realised you had dropped their gorgeous and they didn't have a chance,
that's
did they?
It, that's it. There's no point in them even trying, because you'd have gone for me anyway.
La Légion Étrangère, because a real name in French for Légion, Légion Étrangère, which means Strangers Legion.
I thought it was
yeah.
Stranger.
Anyway, they got these two officers from just outside. Sure. Anyway, they took me back to the officers' mess. Anyway,
got the hots for her at the moment. So, you know, I want to keep her going as well. So we're giving each other a lot of support.
He's keen on anything that wears a skirt. That's all I have to say about it, really.
Well, I've come to the back of the truck again and I'm joined by Uma and Dr. Hannah. Now, what's going on here? I mean, we see a bit of a heart machine here. What is this?
I've had a few concerns about some of the truckers.
Right.
And I've been doing a few checks around and some checks on...
Yeah, carry on.
A few checks on Uma here.
Right, and how's he looking?
He's looking good, but I'd like to take him to one side, if you don't mind. Just
really?
Do a few more checks.
You want to take him to one side for some tests?
Yes, a few more
okay.
checks.
A few more checks, okay. Well, in that case, he hasn't actually had permission to take his hand off the truck yet, but I'm going to say, if you want to do the tests, I give you the authority to take your hand off the thing. This doesn't disqualify you. It's just that Dr. Honor wants to do a few tests on you. Are you agreed with that?
Yeah.
It doesn't disqualify you. I'm giving you the permission to do that, and you come back to finish the contest if everything's okay. You're off. Take him away. Okay. That's okay. Off you go. Okay. Well, I'm actually going to have a chat to some of the girls. Debbie, don't take your hand off the truck. How are you
I'm
doing,
not
my
going
darling?
To. Very well indeed, thanks, Dale.
Now, what I happen to know is your husband's been in bed all day.
He has.
Has he been telling you? Now, he's your co-pilot.
Yes, he wanted to get involved, but to be realistic, this is about the extent of the involvement. He's been absolutely marvellous, very supportive. But the sad fact of the matter is, he was supposed to be the original contestant, and he clearly wasn't up to it. That's why I'm here.
Right, now, I happen to know the hubby has turned around and said that if you don't win the truck, he's going to divorce you.
Yeah.
Is that the truth?
It's not a situation we're going to find ourselves in.
OK, well, listen, I wish you continued luck. Don't take your hand off the truck. I'll see you later.
Cheers.
Let's have a chat to Mary. Mary, how are you doing, darling?
Good.
I have to say, you are the strong, quiet, silent type, aren't you? And I know that you're not as chatty as some of the other players, the other contestants here. Are you enjoying yourself?
Yeah, yeah, I am. I'm enjoying myself, yeah.
Psychological ploy, maybe, the quiet treatment? Or is it just the way you are?
I don't think I'm that quiet, actually.
You know?
I think getting told this, yeah.
Yeah? I know that you're an insomniac anyway, so you go without sleep anyway. Are you finding this just a walk in the park for you?
No, not really, because it's quite physical. I mean, you are standing and holding things, and normally, if I'm at home, I will be sitting down, so it is quite difficult.
Getting on with Jason all right?
I am, yeah.
Yeah? OK, well, I wish you continued luck. I'm going to chat to the other girls. We've got to chat with Kay.
Hello.
How are you, darling?
I'm all right, thank you.
So what's it like?
It's all right. Sometimes it hurts your feet and you have to change your socks a lot.
But yeah.
He is absolutely hilarious.
David is a laugh.
He's
a
really
laugh.
Really funny.
So what would you say is the worst time of the day or night for you?
A bit of both, really. You like that all the time. You don't know what you're doing.
I hate to say this, not trying to neg you out, but has there ever been a moment when you thought, actually, I'm off, I'm out of here?
No, there hasn't.
How did you feel when Sophie went? Because she was the first one and the only one so far to go. What was the feeling at the time when she left?
Everyone was in shock, really. It was quite sad because I wouldn't like to be the first, and I'm sure that nobody else would like to be either. And everybody's in it in the same attitude, so it's going to be hard.
Did you choose the right co-pilot?
Definitely. Ian, you're fantastic. You're really, really good.
Have you had any difficulties? Anything that you think, well, actually, I wished I'd done this differently, maybe different shoes, different...
I wish I'd have brought my running trainers, definitely.
Well, next time. Good to see you. Good to see you. Fantastic. Well, it's time to wind up our live update from Lakeside Thurrock, but you can watch the drama unfold live on the Channel 5 website. There'll be a live update later after the movie. I love you, I know. We'll be back live tomorrow evening at 8 to find out who's taken their eye off the ball and the hand off the truck. Stay in touch. This is the most fun you can have with one hand.
Live from Lakeside Thurrock, it's the man who can give a truck. Please welcome your host, Dale Winton.
Welcome to Touch the Truck, and we're into day 3 of the challenge, which means our touchers have been feeling the steel for nearly 54 hours. And while 10 are sticking with it, 10 have walked away. Here's the deal. Last Sunday, 20 contestants took by this fabulous top-of-the-range Toyota and put one hand on the bodywork. Well, since then, they've had to stay awake and keep that hand in constant touch with the truck. Well, it sounds simple, but believe me, this is the biggest endurance challenge ever seen on British TV. What's more, they'll remain there unsleeping with only one left standing that will win the truck and go away with it on the end of the competition. Quite simply, the one who survives drives. I tell you, the suspension is killing me. Now, we've got a medical team giving our contestants 24-hour support. Believe me, they need it, because since last night's show, we've lost another 9 contestants. So, let's see the ones who've trucked themselves.
First off the truck was Sophie Bracker, who lost her concentration for only 2 seconds. Since last night's show, we've lost the following contestants in this order. Number 2, Tim Ashby. Number 20, Jimmy Trott. Number 4, Colin Caffrey. Number 18, Paul Sinclair. Number 19, Debbie Stinchcombe. Number 9, Pam Hardy. Number 14, Kay Rigby. Number 1, Emer Abdullahu. And number 5, Jason Crump.
Sorry.
Of all these contestants, none put more determination and grit into staying than Paul Sinclair, our evangelical preacher. Earlier in the morning at 2 a.m., Paul, who was extremely tired with sore feet, reached for his Bible, searching for some extra strength to carry him through the contest.
Getting chilly, isn't it?
Oh, dear me. Wrong one.
But Paul was clearly waning, trying everything he could think of to keep himself awake. At 4:20, Paul took his scheduled pit stop, but at 4:35, when the other contestants returned to the truck, there was no sign of Paul, who had finally called it a day.
I wish I could have done it through to the end, but I've got no regrets leaving, because no point if you wind up with a damaged leg. No, I've no regrets at all. It's been fun. And I've met some good folk I hope to meet again.
But the most unfortunate hands-off of the night was poor Colin Caffrey. Colin got caught short between loo breaks and asked the referee for an extra trip to the lavatory. Sadly, this is not permitted in the competition rules.
What's he say? I'm going to have to wet myself then. I'm about to wet myself, I'm being serious. And you're not going to see me wet myself, I'll tell you now, I'll end up lamping you. I promise you. Where's the nearest toilet to be? Over there. Yeah. I've got to go, Anna.
How long is your break? Wait till you break, how long is it?
I can't wait. That's it, I'm going.
Colin!
Kay kissed goodbye to David Guest and to the truck and realised that only the toughest of the tough will see the end of this contest.
Kay's out of it. Go, Kay.
That is the hardest thing I've ever done in my life. Yeah, I do.
You've done really well.
I know. I'm just trying my best, but it's really hard. The person that does that deserves it, really do. You should be really, really strong.
Fabulous. Fabulous, fabulous, fabulous. Well, I'm here with two of those truckers who lost touch in the early hours, Paul Sinclair and Kay Rigby. I'm so sorry, but you look better for the little rest you've had. Paul, how are you feeling?
All right, I've been up, lying up with my feet up in the air for hours.
Well, went out on doctor's orders, didn't you, really?
Yeah.
Was a foot problem, wasn't it, really?
Yeah, people have said my feet have caused them problems for years, but this time it caused me yeah, it was swelling and swelling and swelling.
Yeah.
The pain was unbelievable.
Yeah. If it hadn't been for your feet, do you think you'd have lasted the course?
Definitely longer, no doubt. I had the wrong size, I had tight shoes on,
yeah.
and I couldn't handle it. Definitely, because I was still able to think.
I noticed you were reading the Bible.
Yeah.
And you were sort of like thumbing through the page with one hand. Were you hoping for divine intervention there?
I was trying to do two things. One was to get my mind off the pain. So I was reading about all things that happen as a result of perseverance and pain and suffering. But there came a point when I just couldn't cope.
Well,
it did help though for a good time.
Well, we had you in for the long haul. We did. How are you doing, darling?
I'm all right, thank you. I've got serious rapid eye movement at the moment.
I was going to say when I first came to see you tonight, you said to me, "My eyes are like..." I mean, have you had any kip at all?
I had 7 hours and I still feel exhausted.
So tell me, what happened?
I just at one point I thought I was dreaming awake, and then all of a sudden I woke up and I thought, "What have I been doing for the past hour?" And I was just stood like this, and Jason was looking at me over his glasses, and then I got hysterics, and I couldn't carry on.
I have to say, you were very emotional towards the end, mm-hmm. but I have to say, out of all of the truckers that have come and gone, you left with such style and grace. You were a sweetheart. You went round everybody.
Thank you.
How are you feeling now?
All right. I just wish them the best of luck. I really do. And Dave is a superstar. Go on, Dave.
Okay. Well, we'll catch up with them a bit later on. There we are. But although I thought these two would be all set for the long haul, the mind may be willing, but you know, sometimes the body isn't. Even the favourites are feeling the effects. Have a look at this.
In the early hours of the morning, Tim Ashby, the 3-1 favourite, was taken for a medical check.
Do you want to demic me?
Now this could be a bit of a time so you can back off a bit with the mic as well.
The medics had been keeping a close eye on Tim since the night before.
Basically, his blood pressure's been getting high today. We've been monitoring it. We were set a safe limit by the doctor. He went above that. We've given him 5 minutes rest. It's gone back below. So, for now, it's safe to continue.
Although contestants have varying blood pressures, a high blood pressure can result in serious illness, even a stroke. So after the next checkup, when Tim's blood pressure worsened, for safety reasons, Tim's hand was reluctantly prized from the truck.
If someone can say my health is at risk, I'm 57, my blood pressure is going to be higher in any case. I know the limits I go to. I mean, I take my own pulse regularly. Yeah, yeah. I still should be there.
Feel sick?
Yeah.
Right, and the legs killing me. I can't stay any longer.
Jimmy Trott had trouble all night with his feet. An hour later, the pain had increased to the point where Jimmy felt too ill to continue, and he made the decision that he would throw in the towel when the competition reached its 36th hour.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, run!
When did you decide to go, Jimmy?
When I felt sick. And my leg was killing me. Couldn't do anything.
So, yesterday's favourite is out of the race. Sad pictures, but he's here with me, as well as our expert in endurance, Brian Root. Tim, you were favourite this time last night.
Yes,
so,
yes,
so. Oh, I feel for you. Would you put it down to just bad luck?
Yes, I mean, I was psyched for it. You know, unfortunately, blood pressure went up slightly over what was considered a safety level. It can bring problems, and the decision was taken, and the wise decision to pull me out.
I'm so glad to hear you say a wise decision was taken, because at the end of the day, you knew that it was right, with the blood pressure going up and down, it's the right thing to do.
Yes.
Brian, he was your hot favourite, sitting here this time last night.
Definitely, he still is. I think he's a champion, and everything was going good. His mind was there, his pit crew was doing all the right things.
Yeah.
And in the States, if he was in a contest in the States, they wouldn't have pulled him out.
Really?
Unless his blood pressure got a lot higher than that.
Really?
Yeah.
So you would say that Tim, forgive me talking about you,
sure,
like in the third person here, you say he's a natural.
I think he is, yeah. Okay. Yeah, I'd be his co-pilot if we did another one, sure.
Oh, you would?
Sure.
You'd actually be his co-pilot if he was good to...
Thank you.
I think we have a future team here going on. One of the people you said that you weren't too sure about was Jimmy. And you were right there, weren't you?
Yes. I noticed he was leaning a lot already before he finally dropped out. He was leaning and he would just looked in too much pain. I knew he was ready to go.
Very quickly, apart from Tim, any other surprises of those who've left?
I think Sophie was the only one I was surprised to see go. I didn't know the referees would let her go. She was a looker, you know, so.
That's the game. Well, it's not just physical exhaustion that takes its toll on the touchers. Sometimes they just forget the rules, and our referees and touch judges are always there in case they falter. Have a look at the evidence.
One of the referees has noticed that you've taken both hands off of the vehicle at some point.
It has been a long time.
I'm afraid I'm going to have to disqualify you and issue you the red card. If you'd like to come with me now, okay?
Right. Where was this?
Watch your mind.
The sixth contestant to leave the truck was Debbie Stinchcombe, who was disqualified after a referee saw her hands leave the truck at 4:32 this morning. Debbie was adamant that she had not stopped truck touching all night.
Okay. Took your time to sign.
Video evidence proved that the referees were correct, so let's see what happened at the moment of 4:32.
It says in the rules about standing independently.
And if I'm not standing independently, because if you took my hands away, I'd go, don't tell me.
Let's see the view now from an alternative camera.
Not standing independently, because if you took my hands away, I'd go,
don't tell me. Tell the lady.
Whilst arguing with fellow contestants about the no leaning on the truck rule, Debbie broke the ultimate rule. She stopped touching.
Wonderful, wonderful. I feel for them. So, Debbie's down and out, but I'm here with the truckers who are still in touch. Now, Jerry, how are you holding up? Because we have a little leg thing going on here, don't we?
I had a bit of a leg story, and I also had a wobbly moment this morning as well, but I'm still here. Nearly all of us have got some sort of bandages or some sort of story going on, one form or another, but we're all still here, so it's going okay.
I do notice that we've got the team at that end of the truck, and we've got the team at this end of the truck. Am I reading any sort of rivalry here?
No, I mean, it is a competition, and obviously, you know, we've tried to stay friends as long as possible. I think we're all still friends. There's still talk of going for the American record that our colleagues set over there, 125 hours.
Yeah.
We're all still mates, so it's just how the land sort of has fallen, really.
Yeah, there seem like two camps there.
Well, it's just the front and the back.
OK, well, continued success. You're doing brilliantly, doing brilliantly. Bill, come around here, Bill. Give me a, don't take your hand off to us. Bill. How you doing, Bill?
I'm doing fine, thank you, Dale.
I have to say, you look very fresh and very confident.
Thank you very much.
Are you feeling that way?
Yeah.
Could be on to a winner at the moment. Any psychological warfare going on here between the guys and the girls?
Well, we've tried a few psychological... Well, not psychological, but, you know, thought processing things, sending invisible bees off to people, but it's not really working.
Although they're looking
people,
daggers at
some
you
people
up there.
Reckon they're jumpy, but...
Really?
That might
Are you jumpy?
Nah, I'm ready to go.
Good. Well, I wish you continued luck. Bill, doing well. Mary, you're looking good too, my darling. Mary, tell me something. I've noticed, I've been watching the videotape throughout the day, you seem a bit more talkative, a bit more lively. There's a bit more energy going on here than there was yesterday. How are you feeling?
I'm just as energetic as I ever was, but I think sometimes I'm just shown as being quite quiet, and I don't think I actually am.
When you started this competition, you were the natural insomniac. So, are we feeling at all sleepy now?
I am, actually, because I'm...
Oh, are you?
Yeah, because I'm an insomniac, but not standing up on my pins all day, basically. I'm lying down, so I am feeling the strain.
OK, what about the breaks? Are you making the most of your breaks?
I am. I tend to eat everything I can on my breaks.
And, how are you finding your co-pilot?
He's there most of the time, but he really does need his sleep, so I tend to send him home.
Got a weird message for you on the website. This is from someone that obviously knows you. And it's a message for you, Mary. It says, can't believe that you've not had an argument yet. What's all that about, then?
I'm supposed to be very argumentative, which is probably true.
Are you?
But everyone in the house, we generally got on quite well with.
Well, I think you're great. You're all doing brilliantly. I just want you to carry on. Fantastic. Well, they're all hanging on in there. After the break, I'll be back with our other truck touchers and seeing what the next few hours have in store. You know, they're not going anywhere. Make sure you don't as well. I'll see you soon. Well, I'm back with Brian Root, who's won 16 trucks in competition. So he's seen all of this before. Now, Brian,
Yes. Tell
me, it's 54 hours into the game. How do you think they're feeling?
I think they're all in massive pain. The bottoms of their feet are hurting, their lower back is sore, and the brain it comes and goes. I mean,
right.
For a few hours they're fine, and then they drop into a slump, and then they come out of it a couple hours later. So.
Right, well, let's get down to specifics. Okay. Who's doing what?
All right. Well, Bill, the historical reenactment guy, he's a surprise, actually. I didn't think he'd still be here. He's wearing his heavy medieval boots the whole contest, and he's wearing knee braces. I think he's a little overweight, so I don't think he's out of there. Jerry, the eco-warrior, in all the contests I've done, I don't think I've ever seen a cigarette smoker win, so he's out of there. Wendy, she's really light frame, and she's fit. But she's a little too hyper. She's a dancer. I think she's going to dance off the truck.
Right. Oh, really?
Christopher, another smoker, and he's wearing Walkman, you know, Walkman radio thing. He's going to reach up and adjust his headphones, and he's out of there. Bobby is a dark horse. I think he's pretty fit, and he's comfortable being with himself, just
kind of, he doesn't talk a lot. I think he's got a good chance. And Davinia, she's really petite, but she's not doing anything on her break. She's just sitting there talking to people, and she's not resting. I think that's going to cost her. Adam, another smoker, out of it. David, he's already hearing voices from the astral plane right now, so I think he's gone. Sylvester is a marathon runner. He's eating a good diet, and his mom, Daphne, is really helping him out a lot. And then Mary... Mary drank a half a bottle of tequila before the contest, so I think that's going to affect her in the long run. So.
Okay, what about the mental games that people play in this sort of competition?
I think towards the end it's going to be more of staring each other down and saying, you know, you're looking really bad. And things that I've done in particular is I wear sunglasses, mirrored sunglasses, so not only can they not see my bleary eyes, but they have to look at their own bloodshot eyes.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I heard a story about pizza where you had them all got free pizza.
Well, that was
for why?
That was kind of sneaky. I wanted them to think I was their friend, so I bought them a triple sausage, triple cheese pizza, and I would let them give that to them on the break, and they'd eat that, and in an hour they'd be out.
That makes them slow.
Oh yeah.
Okay, cool. Yeah. Well, thank you, Brian. Of course, all this good advice is no use to the truckers who are no longer here. I have grown to love them all, I really have, but sadly, here are a few more we said goodbye to since last night.
Pam Hardy started having a spring clean on top of the truck and made the fatal error of taking both hands off.
Pam, yeah. You removed both hands from the truck when you were moving the personal stereo.
Yes.
I'm afraid I'm issuing you with a red card. You're now disqualified from the competition.
Have a good one. Poor thing here.
Keep in mind, these are the sort of things that happen.
Did you realise when it happened? What happened?
I did, but I had to assume that I'd picked it up and taken both my hands off, but because my vision wasn't good. It was starting to sort of waver a little bit.
And Emer, our Kosovan bodyguard. This morning at 10:28 a.m, Emer showed the first signs of cracking under pressure. Much to his fellow contestants' horror, he began talking to them in his native language.
Që janë dësmunje që nuk më fletë, për pe pa gjumësis që vine, që ja ka njësë më horë.
How long till he goes on his break?
Shortly after, Emer broke the golden rule and momentarily took both hands off the truck.
I was so sure that I'm going to win, but after 2 days, it's just get to the bad dream and finish.
Well, I'm back at the truck with some of our survivors to share their hands-on experience. David, before I chat, I have to say to you, I'm giving you the yellow card because we saw you leaning a bit too often.
Sorry about
that. And the judges said to me, Dale, you've got to tell David, if he leans one more time, it's the red card and you have to go. But I want to ask you about psyching people out, because you're into this astral plane thing. Does it work?
Well, you know that people can move objects by the power of their mind, Dale.
So what have you done?
So what we've done, we got together, my friend and I, and we decided to move people in a similar manner.
Has it worked?
Yeah, we tried it on Yuma 5 minutes before he got up and walked away from the truck.
Are you kidding? You tried it on Yuma?
No, not kidding.
Sylvester, is he for real?
Absolutely true.
Absolutely
true. At the end of the day, it's them and us.
Yeah.
This end of the truck is not going to be the weakest link.
Are you going to be standing here at the very end?
We reckon.
Very end.
Cool, cool. I wish you luck. I'm going to talk to some of the others now. Look, Adam. The support you've got here, Adam. Tell me, you feeling okay?
Feeling really good.
Feeling really good. Now, you two are really sort of working as a team here, aren't you?
Yeah.
You know, and I just wondered, you know, is there something going on here, maybe?
No, it's just team stuff. It's still going to be really tough. Everyone's still keen, and they all still look in good condition.
Yeah.
I think if we help to keep each other awake and let them keep dropping off, eventually, hopefully, it'll be us two, and then it'll be a then we'd be on our own.
How do you feel about David psyching you out?
I wouldn't say I'd noticed.
Okay. Well, until now, our truckers have been absolutely brilliant in the wee hours and during the daylight hours. But I have to tell you, sometimes it's not just the middle of the night when things go wrong. Have a look at this.
Late this afternoon, Jason Crump, our 6'8" former pro basketball player who holds 17 caps for England, lost his concentration and went through hoops before leaving the truck.
Like we're enjoying it. That can't be right now, though.
Jason has battled through the pain barrier. It's just months since he had a knee operation, but it was the sleep deprivation that got him.
I went back upstairs to get some food to prepare for him and came back down here and realised he was missing from the car. He started to hallucinate and he actually just walked away from the car without realising. So he's fine, you know, he's healthy, he's fine, blood pressure's fine and he's looking good. He just feels like he's failed a bit at the moment.
It wasn't me that walked away from the truck. It was... I started dreaming that I was talking to somebody. I couldn't feel my whole body. The next thing I knew, the ref grabbed me and my arms were in the air. And I realised what had happened, you know, and that was it. I just never experienced anything like it in my life.
Well, our sleep deprivation expert, Dr. Chris Alford from University of West of England, is here. Chris, tell me, you've studied people all your life in sleep deprivation. You brought with you a computer. What does this actually mean?
Well, we've had a lot of fun here, though. We've been measuring the contestants during the competition, and there's a couple of results I'd like to show you.
Right.
The first one we've got here is a memory test. So this is looking at thinking ability,
right,
memory, and it's like a telephone number recall. You give them a number and they've got to say it back to you.
All right, so this is, and under any normal circumstances, they could do it like that?
Well, you don't always get it right. It's 10 digits we've given them, so it's quite a hard task. They've got to remember 10 numbers.
So what does this tell me here?
What it's showing us, in fact, we've divided it up into the survivors and the people who've dropped out, and the survivors are actually scoring better. Their graph's going up, so they're showing that they're motivated and focused and able to hang on for those few seconds and really think and doing the biz, whereas the people who've dropped out have stayed at a level, but they're not doing as well as the survivors. So that's the memory test.
Okay, so you're happy with that. Now, also, what about the physical test?
Right. I thought you'd like this one, so we brought this one along. This is the squeezy thing for you.
Okay.
So this is a hand dynamometer, so you've got to squeeze it and see how strong you are.
I've never used one of these. So each and every one of them have had a go at this, have they?
They have, yeah.
Do you want me to squeeze it now?
Please do.
Oh, it's... You have to be butch to do this.
You have to be butch to do this. You're doing very well. You're doing very well. You've got a good strong grip there, I can see.
You don't know the how.
Right, if we can just focus on the group results. That's
can enough. I let go?
That's plenty. I think you've outperformed everybody tonight, so there we go. On the strength test, we're finding that people are actually going down as we'd expect because they have to hang on to that thing for quite a long time. And we can see again that the people who've dropped out are actually dropping faster than the people who are actually still in. So we're seeing a bigger drop off in muscle fatigue with the people who've dropped out.
Now the physical thing is interesting, but I'm curious about the rapid eye movement. Very quickly, tell me about the rapid eye movement.
Eye movements, be a pleasure. Let's have a quick look at this one.
Because this is when you measure how well people are doing by, if they can say they're wide awake, but in actual fact, you can tell who's going to last and who's not.
We've been looking at the blinks. So when people begin to nod off and go into microsleeps, they just get that sort of action like that. And so we've been taping that on the video, and you can see that's everybody there, but across the days, their slow blink rate's going up, so you can see they're steadily getting more tired.
Very quickly, who's going to win?
We've got our odds earlier on, looking at Bill, look very good earlier on, but they're all going up and down.
Okay, well, it's been great to talk to you. That's Chris's opinion. Let's see what those latest odds are.
It's a smaller team today and the odds are getting tighter. He's gone from middle of the field to rank outsider. It's astral projectionist David Guest at 28-1. Wendy Hesketh is at 25-1. Davinny McFarlane is at 12-1. And the man with the mane, Bill Curd, has the same odds. The Romeo cabbie, Adam Giorgio, joins City slicker Bobby Shaw at 8-1. The top four is where the competition is really tough. Eco Warrior Jerry Middleton is at 7-1. Marathon Man and Logistics Manager Sylvester John is at 6-1. Super cool insomniac Mary Moore is unfazed at 11-4. But back in the top spot, it's the military man who's taking it all in his stride, Christopher Robinson, at 5-2.
I have to tell you, during that videotape, David Guest, who I was chatting to earlier, was red carded for leaning on the truck. He's had to be disqualified from the rest of the contest, but well done, David. I'm sorry, we're going to miss you. There you go. Well, the odds are getting closer. I'm now talking to Bobby, and we've got Chris, and we've also got Wendy here. How are you doing, Bob?
Very good.
Yeah. Looks like you could well be the winner, so we believe.
That's exactly what I said at the beginning.
You're keeping yourself very cool. How are you feeling?
Very positive, very confident.
Yeah. Are you going to miss Uma? Because you look like a bit bewildered when he left.
You know what? I was actually very surprised. I mean, he's very young, very fit. I mean, he's worked as a bodyguard, but his whole tactics was just different.
Well, I wish you continued luck. And you, Chris. And Wendy, don't take your hand off the truck. We've got to go. That's it from Lakeside Thurrock for another day. Please join me tomorrow when some of these plucky truckers will still be staggering on for a 78-hour marathon so far. Can you believe it? Or you can log on to the Channel 5 website and follow the action live. Keep on trucking, and I'll see you tomorrow night.
What really clinched it was when I did the interview with Dale, and Dale said to me, you've got your two warnings, one more and you're gone. And a little voice said to me, you're gone now.
Live from Lakeside Thurrock, it's the man who can give a truck. Please welcome your host, Dale Winton.
Fabulous. Good evening. Welcome to Wednesday's live edition of Touch the Truck. Now, as you must know by now, we're here at Lakeside Thurrock with a truck. Last Sunday afternoon, that's 78 hours ago, 20 people put their hands on it in order to win it. By Monday night, we were down to 19. Yesterday, we started the show with 11. And by the end of last night's show, we were down to 10. Would you believe now we're left with a final three? That's right, another seven have dropped off since last night. At 2 o'clock this afternoon, our remaining truckers entered their third day of deprivation. Let's have a look at this landmark moment.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Of course, 78 hours with no sleep and having to stand unsupported with their hands in constant contact with this 4x4 have taken their toll on our last three truck touchers. Our medical teams of doctors and psychologists, as well as the St. John's ambulance team, have been here 24 hours a day doing the most fabulous job. So, since last night's show, we've lost another seven touchers. Who were they? Let's find out.
3 days, 20 people, no sleep. One by one, they've suffered and walked away. David Guest hallucinated and collapsed live on last night's show. Since then, we've said goodbye to Bill Curd, Wendy Hesketh, Adam Giorgio, Bobby Shaw, and the bookie's favourite Christopher Robinson. That was followed by yet another shock when super cool insomniac Mary Moore became a victim of paranoia and bailed out. The contestants should have been sworn enemies from the start, but for many, touching the truck has forged solid friendships. Adam and Davinia proved no exception.
You've already dragged me this far.
I have not.
You have.
You've been brilliant yourself.
I think I didn't want to target and know where I was.
Totally had enough. I said you've totally had enough.
The only thing is what I'm carrying on for at the moment is because you're still here and because of everyone else. I ain't going on no longer. Alright, so make sure we finish, yeah? I think she's going to do it. She's really determined. She got me as far as I got then, which is really good of her. She kept pushing me. She kept helping me.
Got to do it for him now, all right? He's done this. You can see how he is and how gutted he is. He'd be so pleased if you'd done it. They say he won't make it better. Go on, go on.
I don't like being beaten by a girl.
Two girls.
So there you have it. I fell for them, they were all brilliant. Now all our touches are bonded with each other, but people dropping out does have a huge effect on the others. Now I'm here at the truck with Davinia and her co-pilot Ian. Now Davinia, you formed quite a bond with Adam there. How did you feel now he's gone?
Devastated.
Really?
Yeah.
Has it changed your game plan at all? Has it made you weaken at all?
Yeah, it has. It kind of made me very disheartened to start with.
Please don't. You're fabulous. You're doing so well, as are our other two. You're here with Ian, who's your co-pilot.
An uncle
as well. Has he been a tower of strength to you?
Most definitely, yeah. He's my strength.
How's she been holding up?
She just surprised me. I mean, the longer it's gone on, she's just... I can't express how I feel about her.
You know? Yeah.
It's just so surprising. I couldn't do what she's done.
Well, what's interesting is the first thing you said to me when you arrived tonight was, Davinia is a star, she's been brilliant, but Dale, I haven't had any sleep either. So have you been working, like, round the clock?
I mean, I couldn't do what she's done, but the way that I feel is what I've done as much as I could do. I've had no sleep. I've had 4 hours sleep, less than her, and she's had no sleep. I'm forgetting things. I just don't know what I'm saying half the time.
When she comes off for a break, has she had any unusual requests? Has she thought, I mean, you've probably got a milkshake ready or a power drink. Has she thought, I fancy a bar of chocolate or I fancy something else?
Well, we had a game plan, and our game plan was going to work between us what she wanted and what we wanted or what she needed. If she needed a chocolate, I would decide, and we would both decide if it was really right for her to take the chocolate. And it works blinding. Everything's worked absolutely perfect. She's been great. I mean, she's really been low.
Well, keep going, and you've got the perfect co-pilot by the sound of it. We're all with you, aren't we? Yeah! We are, as we are with the other two. Well, the three that are still standing here around the truck don't include the hot favourite, the fella in the frock, Christopher Robinson, who was disqualified this morning. It breaks my heart, but let's have a look at his fall from grace.
Hot favourite former Foreign Legionnaire Christopher Robinson was off the truck at lunchtime today. It all started going wrong last night when Chris received a yellow card for leaning on the truck. He found it hard to come to terms with the decision.
Oh, I got a, I feel a unjust yellow card last night. I've mentioned it to Harriet and she said she will investigate it.
Oh, you got one yourself?
Yes, I did. And it was at the back of this vehicle here. Basically, in the position I am in now, with a distance from me boarding to the overhang of the car, I have to lock my arm, as you can see, even on this one. And the locked arm constitutes as leaning against the vehicle. And I, with my knowledge of physics, find it very difficult to believe that you can actually, a flat surface roof of a vehicle can aid me in any way to support me. I just slide right along it. And I had no choice but to lock my arm. It's the only way to reach a vehicle. I've been in excellent health throughout this competition, trained very hard for it, and I felt I explained the situation to the referee. He gave me the ticket, and his attitude was very stubborn. Well, I can give a ticket and I can reverse him, but on this occasion I won't.
Finally, the tough guy was busted with both hands off at 11:30.
But what I was really thinking was, like, less nuclear weapons. Hands, mate. Hands.
Yeah.
Hands. You want a break now?
No, you're like chewing gum. That's what you're allowed.
That doesn't mean you can take your hands off.
I don't see why.
Game over.
So yesterday's favourite, Christopher Robinson, has gone, but he's back with me after a good rest, as is Wendy Hesketh, who went out in the early hours. And I'm really quite pleased to see you back together. The double act continues, doesn't it? What was it you said? Can I put my tongue in your ear? Do you remember that?
Yeah, we do remember that, yeah.
Well, I remember it was a bit of romance going on in here. Now, the other thing is, to leave the truck is devastating. What was your downfall? Come on, Chris, what happened?
My downfall was just lack of concentration at the end of the day. I was just listening to another competitor, and in excitement of it all, I wasn't thinking totally straight, and I took my hands off the truck.
Yeah.
That's what rules are.
That's concentration, isn't it?
Yes, it was.
I know. And also, Jerry was brilliant with you, as we saw. Jerry was going, hands. He was trying to help you, bless him. He was a darling. He was trying to say, put your hand back on the truck. Maybe no one saw, but we did. Wendy, what about you, sweetheart?
Same thing. I dropped my personal stereo and actually went to pick it back up. Plonked my hand back on, thought everything was fine. It was just a very natural thing to do, to pick it up, plonk it back on the top, and next thing my earphones are pulled off me.
And this was like 4 o'clock in the morning, wasn't it?
Yeah.
So were you busted straight away? Did it come immediately that it happened, the judges?
Because I literally lifted up from the floor, my earphones taken off me, stopped mid-dance. And
oh, right, mid-dance.
It. Mid-dance.
So what have you done since then? Have you both had a good sleep?
Well, I came off about 12 o'clock and my co-pilot was there for me, as he has been all throughout the show. We had tears, never beers, never pub. Haven't had a chance yet.
You haven't had a sleep? What about you, Wendy?
I've had a little bit of sleep. My mum and dad and everyone came down to spur me on, and I flopped out 15 minutes before they got here, so they gave me a quick kiss and cuddle, sent me off to bed, and now they've gone back up north.
Now, the three that are remaining, how are they feeling now, do you think? What goes through your mind? Well, the boredom, presumably.
Yeah, I think a lot of it's boredom, but I think at this stage, and respect to those three that are left, it is very, very difficult, and I think now just going through their mind is just hanging on.
Yeah.
They've done all the hard work now, and they've just got to hang on in there.
Yeah. You two, as I said earlier, work very much as a double act. I mean, very much together. So when Wendy left before you, did that affect your performance, do you think?
No, I don't think it did. I think it was just down to lack of concentration and the nature of the game. When Wendy left, it was a lot of fun when she was here, and when she left, it actually gave me a boost to get on and do the job that I was here to come to do.
Now, the other thing I want to ask you about, how can I put this delicately? You wore a variety of frocks while you were standing there, and a lot of people were thinking, what's he on about? I mean, he's a well-armed man with the muscles and the tattoos, and he's wearing a frock. What was that all about?
What that's about, basically, being ex-military and so on, we have a tradition in military and so on, when you've had a good session with the lads, you end up in a charity shop, and you just make total fools of yourself.
Yeah.
So no, it comes naturally to me.
I think I should have been in the army then, don't you? What are you going to say? Sorry.
He just wants to look better than me. That was what it was all about. He just wanted to overshadow me. Get stand there in a dress.
And well, I've got to ask, was there any romance going on there? Because you were getting quite friendly. I wondered, is there any budding romance here?
Not at all. We were just comrades from the beginning. I mean, you know, it just happened that we got on really, really well. And then half a day had gone and we thought, well, this is fantastic. We'll just keep it going. And And that's what we did. We were linked the whole way.
Would either of you or both of you do one of these competitions again?
I wouldn't.
No, you shook your head.
No, I wouldn't. I really enjoyed the experience of it, and I'm really chuffed that I actually stuck it as far as I did. And the experiences that I had, the troughs were really deep and, you know, and high, and all of that is...
You'd go through it again. Yeah. What about you, Chris?
I don't think I would, no. I really enjoyed the experience, so...
We won't put you through it again, Chris, but thank you both. You are darlings, and I love you for doing
this. Thank you, Dale.
OK, well, they're all in great shape. They say that laughter is the best medicine, and maybe that's why they're still here. Have a look at this.
Stop it.
Well, I'm back at the truck with Sylvester and his co-pilot Daphne. And we saw you laughing there. You do like a good laugh, don't you, Sylvester?
I do.
You've stopped laughing now. Are you feeling? How are you feeling?
I'm just trying to get myself back on track now. Obviously, through the laughing, my voice is very, very hoarse.
Yeah.
Been laughing too much.
Now, I know that earlier you said that Chris, who I've just been speaking to, was a hot favourite, and you considered him to be your main competition. How did you feel when he dropped off earlier today?
I have to be quite frank. I was a bit disappointed because I know he's an engineer, and they don't lose.
They don't lose.
So I was a bit upset with that, to be honest.
Be honest. Are you surprised you're still standing here?
Yes.
I'm surprised as well.
Now, Daphne, you've been his co-pilot throughout this whole thing.
Tell me about it.
I know.
My feet ache.
Your feet ache. Think how his feet must feel. Any strange requests in the breaks?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Wanted my daughter.
Really?
Said he was feeling randy. I thought you're looking at the wrong person.
So, are you trying to tell me he was hoping to use the 15-minute break of her conjugal visit then,
perhaps?
Yeah,
but she wasn't here. She was at work.
I think the idea is to preserve your energy, not lose it. I think that's what it's all about. The fact that we're down to three now, does that make you feel stronger?
Yes.
Are you going to still be here to the very end?
Yes. Wonderful, yes.
Well, you've been brilliant.
Thank you. Keep going.
Well, I'll be back after the break to see how this marathon is taking its toll on not only our truckers' bodies, but also on their minds. So, I'll see you in a couple of minutes.
Hi. This is it tonight. It's going to be the last night here.
Yeah?
Okay. I'm going to clear up. Why? Because it's ladies' night.
the first morning, blackbird has spoken like the first bird.
Welcome back. Now, throughout this whole ordeal, our contestants have had their co-pilots by their sides. Now, I'm back at the truck with Jerry and his co-pilot, Steve. So, you've been doing a sterling job, and you, I have to say, Jerry, all of you remaining on the truck are stars in your own right, but you particularly were a sweetheart. What did you think when Chris took his hands off? Because you were going, trying to help him.
I couldn't believe it, because he'd set the standard for the sort of contest all the way through, right from the beginning, and he... Not only that, but he'd also played a really, like, strong psychological hand. I was starting to think that I would never, you know, no one would be able to beat him. I didn't think that I'd be able to beat him, and then suddenly...
Are you saying that his psychological ploys are working on you against you, then?
Well, he could obviously do it, but, you know, he convinced me that he was going to beat everyone, including me.
Now, I happen to know you're a bit of a green campaigner, and you don't really... I mean, you want the truck, but not for the truck. What's going on here, then?
I'm going to sell the truck if I'm the one who wins it, and hopefully start a new political party.
Are you?
And run in the next general election.
Well, we wish you well with that. Now, your co-pilot throughout this whole event has been Steve. Sterling job you've done here, my friend. What would you say were his greatest qualities at standing at the... I mean, how has he managed to maintain this?
Well, he's just as fresh now as when he started. I think he's just so determined. He's very strong-willed, very good.
Is every break the same? Is it the same routine? Have you got, like, a military operation going here?
Everyone's different. What he wants, and he gives me impossible tasks sometimes. A cup of tea 2 minutes before he goes off.
So what a cup of tea!
Where am I going to get one from?
How important is it that you've had Steve as your co-pilot, Jerry?
I mean, it's taken both of us to get this far. So, like all the other contestants say, there's two of you doing it, and plus all the people around as well. It takes everyone to get this far.
Well, continued success. Thank you, Steve. Thank you, Jerry. So, while it's sweetness and light between the contestants and their co-pilots, you know, sometimes there can be a bit of a needle between the touches themselves. Have a look at this.
It's all been very good humoured around the truck up until this morning, when tempers finally began to fray. Mary Moore accused Davinia McFarlane of causing another contestant to let go of the truck, and it all kicked off.
Sorry?
I took my hand off the car.
What? Can you not speak for yourself? Excuse me, can you not speak for yourself?
Excuse me, who are you?
Who are you?
Excuse me.
Excuse me. You're okay,
please, don't start.
Like I said, are we friends now? You don't mind talking to me now?
I'll ask.
Friends or no friends, you know?
No, exactly.
We're not in nursery school here. I'll be your friend.
Forty-five minutes later, and poor Sylvester is still caught in the middle of this argument.
Don't get other people involved. Don't get Jerry involved.
Jerry. Do you know I lifted my hand up on the car?
Don't get him involved.
No, but
I mean, it was all right.
I'm talking to you, not to Jerry.
Yeah, last night.
You know, it was all a little bit of game plan. David was saying who was getting going out first.
I just asked him. Did you see
his
hands up?
Don't create problems.
Oh, shit. I'm not talking to you.
Don't make problems. Don't cause frictions between people. I'm talking to you, lady, woman, whoever you are.
Well, I'm here with one of those two, Davinia. We watched with interest what was going on there. Was that just tiredness, or was there generally a bit of a rivalry there, a problem there?
Yeah, it was nothing personal. It was just, like, things happening and things tend to get to you and arguments happen.
Do you think that if you weren't perhaps so tired, you'd have probably just not been quite so fractious with each other?
I'm not too sure. Maybe there would have been arguments still. I mean, she said on her tape that she was argumentative.
That's true. Well, you've done brilliantly. What's it like just being one of the last three?
Yeah, it's fantastic.
Is it?
Yeah.
Well, good luck to all of you. I mean, this is fantastic. Now, Bobby Shah was one of the favourites to win this truck, but earlier today, his body and mind went their separate ways, and it was all caught on camera. Have a look at the evidence.
Okay.
Yesterday, Bobby was amazed at Emer's language skills. Today, he had some of his own.
Tiens. Ah oui, je t'aime de Lijon. Je t'aime de Lijon. What's going on?
Bobby's dedicated mother has been with him from the start.
So it's about 749 at the end of the year. So it's about 85 quid a week. Yep.
No problem.
No? You resign subject to negotiations. Or I'm taking it. We've won. Okay? I've won. Full stop, it's over. You resign. You resign.
It soon became obvious to everyone that Bobby's trucking days were over.
All right. So yeah. Nice and slow.
Poor Bobby. But I can tell you that he's fine now and back in the pink. Well, I've been joined by another trucker who lost touch last night. Bill Curd is here with our expert in endurance, Brian Root. Bill, the hot favourite for a little while there. What happened?
My calves just were solid. They were round, they were just cramped up. There was no swelling or anything, they were just full of cramp.
Yeah.
And after about 3 or 4 hours, I just couldn't take the pain anymore.
Right.
Which has really gutted me because my brain was still going.
You were doing brilliant. Also, you flew through all the tests. Physically, you were great until your leg. Well,
yeah.
I'm sorry.
It happens, though, doesn't it?
Brian, what do you reckon here? I mean, he
I've
almost
what
did
you
it,
say.
Didn't
you
he?
You think it would be a kiss of death on people.
No, Bill was actually, he was looking good mentally, and I knew with the boots on, I think that probably had something to do with the cramping, and I knew that was going to be a problem there.
You've been here before many times. What are they feeling right now?
Probably most of the pain is, they're so used to it, they don't really feel it anymore. It's all now just trying to keep the eyes open and keep the brain working.
As you look at our three remaining truck touchers, what are you thinking? Who's it going to be?
Well, at this point, I think the main thing is getting oxygen to the brain. And
right.
to do that, you want to keep moving around. And Jerry's been moving around pretty good. Davinia, on the brakes, she'll run to the brakes, run to the loo or wherever she goes. So that's good to keep the blood flowing. So, and Sylvester has been kind of just calm, you know, other than rubbing the truck like that. So I'm kind of leaning towards Davinia now.
Oh, so you've changed allegiance.
Yeah, kind of good.
What I find interesting is I love the way Sylvester is polishing that truck.
Yeah.
It's the cleanest truck I've ever seen. Is that what you do? Is that because it's my truck and I'm going to polish it?
I don't know, but I've actually seen a couple other people do that in contests, and they've gone towards the end, but they're like the 34th to go, and I guess it's a way to focus.
Yeah. Out of curiosity, we've got Bill here. What would be the first thing you'd have done if you'd come off a marathon like that?
Once he came off?
Yeah, what would you have done yourself? What would you normally do?
Just find the nearest bed and fall asleep.
That's it.
Exactly.
While all the contestants have their tactics and game plans, the stage in this competition, the only viable option is to just hang on in there. Have a look at this.
We're going there, right, with a very, very positive attitude, OK? Let them know it. They was ready to go earlier. Let them know it, all right? You are the one. You heard the old market screaming it. You're the one that everyone wants anyway, all right? Just make sure that you do it, all right? Don't let no one know if you're in any sort of pain, right?
Come back.
If you can separate his toes, the blood would get to them a lot better, yeah?
It's like having a public bath.
Have you had something to eat, Jerry?
Yeah.
Is that all right?
Yeah.
Sure.
15 minutes.
Try and eat some fruit, because you need fruit toes, yeah?
Fruit toes?
fructose. If you eat fruit.
If you're staying, you stay. If you're going, I support you. You've done well so far. You're the oldest one there. You don't miss it. Let's rub your tummy.
You've got a lot of people that are supporting you out there. Don't think they're not. Don't let your morale go down. Don't get emotional, please. You've got to stick in there. You're going to get it. You're doing so well.
I'll do my best.
Well, it's up to you, my love. It's your decision.
Yeah. We're all behind you, honestly.
Of course we're all behind you.
By the truck with our remaining three plucky truckers, and I've got to tell you, all three of you have had amazing messages on the web. Davinia, a Scottish male aged 28, has written, "Davinia, you caught my eye. I'll be watching keenly now to see what happens. Good luck." And says here, Glenn is sure you will win, and says, "If you cut me up on the roundabout in your new truck, don't forget those L plates, because you don't drive yet, do you?"
No.
So what are you going to do if you win? Well, I wish you luck. We're all with Dav, aren't we? We're all with her. Good. Jerry. Web message for you, Jerry. See, your dress sense hasn't improved over the years. I think you look great. Hang on in there, you can do it. Just think puddings. What's all that about?
I'll have to go with a no comment on that one.
Okay. And it says, one question, Jerry. Who's going to be left facing you in the truck? That's what they want to know.
Out of the other contestants?
Yeah.
No idea.
No idea. Well, wish you luck. Good luck, Jerry. And Sylvester. Message of support. This is great. I love this one for Sylvester. Enough respect from Milton Keynes. Keep polishing away at the bonnet. That's cool. And it says, are you glad you're here? Are you glad you're still here?
Yes, I'm glad.
They want to know that you're glad you're still here, which is great. I can tell you now, you have all broken a world record. Well done. All broken. They've broken the world record. Well, that's it for another day. You can watch live on the Channel 5 website. Now, we're really down to the wire now, but who'll make it through the night and into the home straight? Who knows? Join me tomorrow and see if any of our three truckers is still standing. Keep on trucking!
Don't take your hands off the truck, yeah?
Live from Lakeside Thurrock, it's the man who can give a truck. Please welcome your host, Dale Winton.
Hi. Welcome to Touch the Truck, live from Lakeside. Well, as you can see, I am the only one left touching this truck this evening, which means, yes, we have a winner. Now, the decisive moment came at midnight last night when, after 81 hours and 42 minutes and 13 seconds, we were left with only one toucher with their hands on the truck. What happened? Was it by accident or design? Well, in a few minutes, we'll be meeting our worthy winner. But first, this competition has been a huge challenge for each of our 20 contestants who, on Sunday afternoon, put their hands on this car and then stood without sleep until they couldn't take it anymore and just dropped off. And it was only last night we were down to the final three. But let's begin by having a look at the other 17 and their partings from the paintwork.
First off the truck was Sophie Bracca after only 9 hours. There was a massive call on Tuesday night when blood pressure nabbed Tim Ashby. Swollen feet scuppered Jimmy Trott. Nature called Colin Caffrey's name. Paul Sinclair stopped trucking in the early hours. Explaining the rules led to Debbie Stinchcombe's downfall, and Pam Hardy needed both hands to do some spring cleaning. Trucker's tiredness overcame Kay Rigby. Hallucinating and speaking in Albanian, Emer Abdullahu went out in style. Jason Crump had a waking dream at 3 o'clock Tuesday afternoon, and in dramatic fashion, live on Tuesday night's show, David Guest. Yesterday was the turn of Wendy Hesketh, who was more interested in picking up her Walkman than holding on. Bill Curd's hair failed to give him the strength of Samson. Adam Giorgio said goodbye to what he saw as a passion wagon. Bobby Shaw left speaking in French and demanding resignations all round the truck. Paranoid Mary Moore left the building, but not before favourite Christopher Robinson threw away the truck over a stick of gum.
But what I was really thinking was like less nuclear weapons. Hands, mate. Hands.
Yeah.
Hands. You on a break now?
No, you like chewing gum. That's what you're allowed.
That doesn't mean you can take your hands off.
I wouldn't see what I mean.
I've been joined by Brian Root, who's been our resident expert in endurance, having won 16 trucks in the States. Amazing. Welcome back.
Thank you.
Brian, around this time yesterday, I said to you, how long is this going to go? And you said to me, I'll give it about midnight. And you were so close, weren't you?
Yeah, well, I don't remember much during my contest, but I do remember when they end, when I win them, you know, so.
What's extraordinary is you were right within seconds there. You kind of knew. We're not going to say who won right at this moment in time. But with your experience, you've been observing the whole event. This is televised as a game show. Right. In America, it's an event at a car dealership.
Right.
Would you say that by being on television as part of a show has helped or hindered our touches?
I think it's actually hindered them. It's made it a lot tougher. Number one, whenever they go on their breaks, and I would always go and lay down and rest, but if they've got cameras right in their face the whole time during the break, they're not allowed to rest really. So, and they also have longer to run to their breaks, where our breaks were right next to the truck. Yeah. So a big difference there.
Now the other thing is that the cameras can give you adrenaline. Did you find that they were coming down after the show had finished? Was that a low point?
I think, the cameras picked them up for maybe 30 minutes or so, but once everything kind of settled down, they went back to their old state, and they figured, oh no, here it is again, the pain and the agony.
I know that when you've been very successful in the States, and as I say, you've won over 16 trucks, you've used psychological ploys, the glasses, feeding them pizza because the cheese slows them down. Have you seen much evidence of that kind of behavior here?
I think apart from just some yelling from the pit crew members towards their own people, it kind of upset a few of the contestants, but I haven't seen too much of those ploys used.
Yeah. And the other thing is there's been a phenomenal interest on the web on this. It's been incredible. I mean, jam-packed all day long. Hmm. People are saying this could become a proper sport, a gold medal sport, an Olympic sport. What do you reckon?
I don't know if it's ready for that yet, but I was thinking it'd be interesting to have the Olympic athletes do this and just see how good they could do. That'd be something.
Would you still be up for doing it maybe as a game show yourself now?
Yeah. This is so much bigger than anything we've had in the States. And this is a great thrill to be here, and I'd love to do it again myself, be up there.
And finally, you've been observing our touches very carefully. A lot of good humor as well, which surprised me. I thought there'd be a bit of antagonism. There was a little bit, but not too much. In America, is it like that?
It's pretty similar, and amazingly, in this contest, if you saw all the contestants, once they dropped out, they had to come back and just cheer on the other contestants and see what happened. And that's
well, they're all here tonight, as we're right. going to see. Well, Brian has been here with our truckers for the last 5 days and got to know them all really well. But by the time Bobby Shaw lost touch with the truck, he wouldn't have known his own mother. Who would have thought that going without sleep could play such tricks on your mind?
I'm going to have to wet myself then. I'm about to wet myself, I'm being serious. And you're not going to see me wet myself, I tell you now, I'll end up lamping you. I promise you. Where's the nearest toilet to be? Over there. I've got to go, Anna.
How long is your break? Wait till you break. How long is it?
I can't wait.
It's only 10 minutes.
Keep going.
Keep going.
Keep
As you saw, by the end of last night's show, we had only three truck touchers left in contact with this Toyota. They were Jerry, Sylvester and Davinia. But who was the next to go? Have a look. Poor Sylvester, I suppose you can only polish a car for so long. Of course, once Sylvester was polished off, our final face-off was between Davinia and Jerry. How much longer could they stand it? Well, after 80 hours without sleep, the smallest lapse of concentration could result in instant disqualification. So, was it a slip of the hand, or was it sheer exhaustion?
So, after last night's show, only the three toughest contestants remained with their hands on the truck. Davinia McFarlane, Jerry Middleton and Sylvester John. And this is what happened. Sylvester hadn't eaten all day and his team were worried that he would lose energy and fall off the truck. But much to the delight of his team, in his evening break, Sylvester regained his appetite in style, eating pretty much everything he could get his hands on. So Sylvester returned to continue polishing the truck, which by now was mesmerizingly clean. But sadly, only a few moments later, his hand slipped off. So at 10:40 p.m. Touch the Truck reached the critical point of the two contestant shootout.
The break, I'll be back with the winner and the runners-up, and of course handing over the keys of this 4x4. Don't go away. Welcome back. Well, our 20 truck touchers have pushed themselves to the limit to keep holding on. We've seen how Colin Caffrey, it became more a matter of holding it in. But now let's really see how Bobby lost it.
What's going on? So it's about 7:49 at the end of the year. So it's about 85 quid a week. Yep.
No problem.
No? You resign subject to negotiations. Or I'm taking it. We've won. Okay? I've won. Full stop, it's over. You resign. Are you resigned?
Bobby, we all felt so sorry for him when he lost the plot. Well, it's time to put you out of your misery and name the winner of this fabulous 4x4. When Sylvester succumbed at 10:40 last night, we were left with only two touchers. Davinia McFarlane, our kickboxing psychology student from London, and Jerry Middleton, our eco-warring potential politician. They were left eye to eye to stare each other out across the truck until one of them gave way. Here's the moment when it happened.
Davinia is in trouble. Jerry knows it and is keeping a close eye on her, but will he make a simple mistake and give it all away? 81 hours in, these two have fought off 18 strong and determined contestants, and now it truly is a battle of mental and physical strength.
Come on, concentrate now.
Sylvester doesn't want it. Nobody's won it yet.
Jerry knows that it's a matter of survival now, but Davinia's condition is causing concern. The level of oxygen in her blood has dropped, as has her heart rate.
You're staying on, right? You're not coming off. But what we do need to do is we need to keep an eye on your pulse, because your pulse is very low, right?
Big deep breaths, and it'll keep that up, Davinia, OK? Not too quick.
Slowly, but deep breaths. Three deep breaths.
How long for the break?
She makes it to her 15-minute break.
When she puts her mind to something, she won't pack up. She won't pack up. The only reason that ever she's not going to do this is if these doctors say that she can't carry on.
Lights.
Yeah,
down,
can you
something.
Turn the lights down.
How does that feel, darling?
Is it possible to turn the lights down?
Right, the doctor's in there with her. We're all leaving her. She's having a power kip. Okay?
It's now, without doubt, the most tense 15 minutes of the entire contest for everyone. If Davinia doesn't make it back from her break, then Jerry has won the competition. Cameras are ready to roll to get the first picture of the man and his machine.
1 minute!
How long have you got? No, you don't have to run, did you?
No, you've got 1 minute.
Plenty of time.
How much time's you got?
45 seconds.
45 seconds.
Everyone is stunned when, amazingly, Davinia McFarlane runs from her pit stop to touch the truck yet again. The competition is not over yet. Davinia is still struggling. Jerry looks physically well, and mentally he's showing no signs of fatigue.
Can I practice for Channel 5 adverts while I'm here? Like, some things are worth staying up for. Channel 5 movie, tonight,
come on,
at 10.
Come on, baby.
Here you go, on his shoulders.
Come on, Bean. Come on, baby.
She ain't giving up, you know. She'll be here till the duration.
I'm there, I'm here. Come on, then. Come on, then, Bean. Come on, Bean. Come on. Please don't let me hurt like this. Please. I love you so much. Please.
Come on, Ben.
You can do it. Just keep focused.
Davinia's oxygen levels are still falling, and the level of concern for her from the medical team, the doctors and the referees is rising.
Hey, I'm David, all right? It's your call, all right? It's your call for the moment, but it will become our call very shortly. Okay? You've done extremely well. You won't be letting anybody down. Alright? But at this stage, you've got to think of your health. Okay?
Come on.
She's on me. Just stay with it. Come on, V.
Where's Vinny?
After further medical tests showed no improvement, Davinia was asked to leave for her own safety.
Listen, if you don't make the decision on your own, they're going to take you off anyway, Davinia.
Davinia, I'm going to have, right? If you don't make the decision now, right, I'm going to just ask you to leave.
I'll come off then.
Thank you.
Right, okay.
Thank you.
Whoa, so there it is. Darling Davinia, she almost made it. She came so close yet so far. But, and I'm tempted to say walking away with it was Jerry Middleton. And he's here now, the vehicle victor of Touch the Truck, the top toucher. It's Eco Warrior, Jerry Middleton! See you. Is this the hand?
No, it's this one.
It was that one, was it? Was it? Oh, they're both of them, really. Congratulations. I mean, look, you pulled a great crowd tonight. You have, haven't you? And we've all been here all week. But you know what's amazing? I'm told, and you've been saying it all along, the truck's got to go. How can you part with something you've become so close to?
Well, because I'm an environmental campaigner, Dale, so I can't be driving around in massive gas-guzzling vehicles, so I'm very pleased to have won it, but I will be selling it as soon as possible.
Right, you're going to sell the truck. So it's done its job for you, hasn't it?
Yes, it has.
So what are you going to use the money for that you're going to get when you sell the truck?
I'm going to hopefully start a new political party, announcing that in the next week, and run in the next general election and come up with some sensible policies.
Fantastic. Was that the sole aim of all this?
It was a way of getting the funding to be able to do that. That was one, it was a great opportunity to be on the programme, and that was my aim, was to get the money to start a political party.
Well, I have got a more good news for you, which is you can go into the Guinness Book of Records now, because you see, the world record is 125 hours, but this gentleman has beat the British record, so he is the British champion. Yeah. I have a lot of memories of this week, as I'm sure you do, but one of the memories I have of you is every time I came to speak to you, you were like this.
I'm still doing it now.
You were dancing away. And do you think that's what kept you going?
I mean, I think somewhere in my head, I sort of realised that to keep the brain working and keep the blood out of your feet, you've got to keep moving.
Yeah.
And, you know, we were, everyone's feet was absolutely aching. Everyone's blood was running down into our feet, and the same with our head. So that I had to just keep moving all the time.
Would you do it again?
Yes.
Would you really?
I think I would, yeah. Or I'd try to do it again.
And as you're standing there day and night with your hand on the truck and you're eyeing up the competition, did you think you were going to be the last man standing?
No, not at all. I mean, all of the competitors, we're all still talking about it now, absolutely amazing experience. And anyone could have won it. And even though when it got down to five people, it just meant there was a one in five chance of me winning it. And it just went down and down and down.
Who was your money on? Obviously, it was going to be you, but apart from yourself, who was your competition?
I thought Chris, for me, set the standard. He seemed to know everything about how to stay awake, what to eat, you know, amazing training that he's had in his life.
Well, that amazing moment when he took the chewing gum and you were going, what are you doing? You were so sweet. You were going, hands. You were trying to help him.
I couldn't believe that he'd taken his hands off. I think if he put them back on quickly, I probably wouldn't have said anything. But, you know, I did say hands a few times. And...
Oh, just a few? Just a few. Well, we'll chat some more in a moment. You know, although there could only be one winner, there were 19 others who put their lives on hold for a chance to hold the truck. They've hauled themselves out of their beds to come back here tonight. So let's welcome the contestants, the co-pilots and referees. Absolutely brilliant. And they're all still bestest mates. Davinia and Sylvester, what do I say to you two? What do I say to you two? Dad, are you feeling okay?
Yeah.
Because, like, you were almost there. Can you remember anything about what happened that last hour or so? Because you look kind of out of it.
Bits and pieces, yeah. When I talk about it, I can remember it. But thinking about it, it's just all a blur.
Was it really? And we took you off at some point because we were worried about your health. You stuck it out. They said you could have carried on, but they advised you not to. It was a pulse thing, wasn't it, really?
Yeah, I think they said I kept forgetting to breathe.
Yeah. You did. So you're holding it in, that's why you weren't getting the oxygen through. Uncle Ian. Where's Uncle Ian? Where is he? I want to wave from Uncle Ian. What a co-pilot. How important do you think his role in it was?
Well, I don't think I could have done it without him.
Really?
Yeah, really.
And Sylvester. Is this truck clean enough for you? You've been polishing it.
Actually, as far as tactics were concerned, when I was actually asked, I couldn't actually think of a tactic.
Right.
But when I put my hands on the truck for the very first time, it actually came to me that my tactic is keep moving, keep polishing.
Really? There was one fabulous moment when you were polishing half of the truck and you said, I want to be moved to the other half of the truck because it's not clean enough. Do you remember that?
I do remember that. What I can say to that is, half a clean truck is not a clean truck.
You nearly polished the paintwork off it. Now, one of the things was you came here to sort of settle a few personal issues with yourself. Did it help?
As far as spiritually, mentally, I've actually achieved two of my personal challenges by completing this challenge. So I'd just like to say thank you to all the shoppers, family, mum, dad, co-pilot. Everybody.
One question, would you do it again? You're thinking about it, you're not sure.
If you ask me today, I will say definitely no. If you ask me tomorrow, I'll say yes.
What about you, Daph? Daph, I'm calling you. What about you, Davinia? I'm obsessed with Daphne. What do you think, Davinia?
Not this year.
You're going to have a good... I'm going to ask you, what was the first thing you did when you came off the truck? Go and have a sleep?
I don't remember.
You don't remember? What about you, darling?
I can't remember. I was out of it.
Well, I'm going to come around and have a chat now to a couple of the other players who were absolutely brilliant. And Uma was a star. Uma, you were talking in what language?
Albanian language.
Albanian. And do you remember, we didn't understand what you were saying, so we had it translated. What was it you were saying in English?
Well, first of all, I saw dreaming, I saw chocolates everywhere.
Yeah, actually, what you actually said in your native language to Bobby, who looked very bewildered, was, I'm looking at chocolate butterflies. And it was, what were you thinking at that moment?
Nothing at all. My body was here, but my mind went just dreaming and dreaming. And actually, when I see the Bobby, I thought I was talking to my co-pilot.
Well, you've been great. Give him a cheer. He's been wonderful, wonderful. I've got to talk to... He has to be... the hero, because... When you gotta go, you gotta go. And I felt for you. Yeah, now, when you look back at it, what was going through your mind?
I could do with a nappy.
Do you wish you'd stuck it out a bit longer?
Definitely, yeah. In my head now, I'm quite gutted that I haven't gone the distance. So.
Well, you gave us the funniest moment in the nicest possible. We love you very much. Give him a cheer. Come on, give him a cheer. Oh. Okay. If it's all right with you, Jerry, can I rest these on your truck for a moment? Because there's something I have to do. I'm going to rest them on there because in my pocket here... I know you're not going to drive it, but the keys to the truck. Jerry Middleton! Congratulations! From me, but you know what? I have one little video to show you what this is all about.
I'm really good. I'm really glad about it.
Brilliant.
I'm not ashamed of anything. I'm just really upset for her.
Great.
I know how she is, right? And I know what she's going through. She's laying there. She knows what's going on, but she just don't want to face it. She don't want to face it. She's going to feel that she's let me down.
She's let no one down.
She's let no one down.
Go on.
Come on, mate.
Nah, it's good for me. Shit happens.
You know, one of the most important things about this particular game is it's not only how long you stand by the truck, it's how good the support that you have with you when you're doing this competition. I think I speak for every contestant and truck toucher here when I say your co-pilot probably was as important as anybody that you could have seen on the day or night. Is that right? And yours was second to none. I have to say, let's bring him down to sail. Give him a cheer. His co-pilot, Steve. Steve. Tell me. Because he's told me that you asked for some very strange things at times of the day or night. What was going through your mind? Were you glad to see him, or were you thinking, I want to see someone different?
No, this must have been the same for all of us. What happens is you look around, and if you can't see your co-pilot or your other supporters, you're alone immediately. It's like right. You and you're just against everyone. As soon as you can't see them there, you panic. And you're running to such a tight schedule with your food, your intake, going to the loo and everything, and they're managing all that for you.
Fantastic. Thanks very much, Steve. Well, that's all from Lakeside Thurrock. We've had a great time for the last 5 days. Thanks to all our truck touchers and our medical teams, and especially the St John's Ambulance for being on hand 24 hours a day. But on the Channel 5 website, there's still a computerised endurance competition going on right now. And I can tell you the current leader is Jason Gruber with 16 hours. But, you know, it's not too late to log on and join in. Meanwhile, everybody here is going for a well-deserved sleep. I'll see you again soon, I hope, with another tactile test. Who knows? It could be you I'll be getting touchy with. Lots of love. Have a good night.